We welcome you to a raucous Steve Coach Cady Arena at the Goggin Ice Center here on this Friday night, the Miami Hockey home opener between the RedHawks and the Bowling Green Falcons, which should be a very good matchup for us on the ice this evening in front of a packed student section here at Oxford. We haven't seen that in a long time. We haven't seen fans in the building in a long time. It's good to have them back as well. With Jack Schmelzinger, Patrick Geshan with you here from high above the ice. It's Goggin Ice Center. All right, Jack, so Miami, four games on the year. They're 1-3 overall. They need to make some noise this weekend. Bowling Green, the same thing after they were kind of disappointed a couple weeks ago in Troy, New York against RPI.
Absolutely, and this is going to be a fast game. These are two teams that are very defensive heavy. They are always trying to be gritty, always trying to hit a lot of size on the top two lines for both teams. No one under 6 foot except for one guy on Bowling Green's second line on those first top two lines. Yeah. This is going to be a physical game, and it's going to be a defensive game tonight.
Yeah, starting lineups being introduced before the game here right now on the ice at Coach Cady Arena. So good to see, Jack, the crowd in the stands this weekend. We were talking with coaches and players that were going to be playing in this game this week, and all they could really talk about was how excited they were that finally we're going to be playing in front of people other than our family or nobody at all. It's so good to have this atmosphere back, and you never really realize it until it's gone and now it's back in here again.
Yeah, absolutely. Everyone that I've talked to at the beginning of this season has said one thing, and it's that they are really excited to come play at Cady Arena in front of fans. It is a raucous, almost a packed house here tonight. The student
section
is packed to this, packed to the brim, and these guys, you can tell that they're excited to play tonight.
Very exciting for two teams, again, that are in very similar positions too. Bowling Green and Miami, a lot of new faces on either program this year as well. And so for the Falcons and the RedHawks, these newer faces, over 11 guys on both teams trying to get acclimated to their new squad. And that's going to be an adjustment tonight for both teams as well early in the year.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting. These teams are both still here early in the season, learning how to play with each other, learning each other's, you know, what makes each other tick, getting the chemistry going. It's going to be interesting to see who can really come together as a team tonight and take away this game here at Cady Arena.
So the Miami starting lineup is introduced right now on the ice. We will step aside and listen to the rest of that, and then our national anthem here for Coach Cady Arena. We will join the public address announcer tonight, and that is Randy Hollowell. Great national anthem performance tonight by the Miami Men's Glee Club. Big staple on campus. They always do a great job with the national anthems here at Steve Cady Arena. All right, get set, ready to go for hockey action here this evening between Miami and Bowling Green. Our starting netminders for the game tonight, Zach Rose will be in the Bowling Green net. He wears number 40, 6'1", 185, junior from Paradise, Newfoundland. played his BCHL hockey at Victoria. 22-year-old is 1-0-1 on the season, 1.90 goals against, and a 920 save percentage for Miami. Ludvig Pearson takes the net at a hit to Sweden, 6'1", 184 sophomore. Three games this year, all three of them starts, 1-2-0 record, 2.7 goals against, 901 save percentage on the year for Ludvig Pearson. Our referees tonight are Joe Sullivan and Andy Thackaberry from the NCHC. Troy Merritt and Logan Belgraf will work the lines for this one tonight. Bowling Green in their standard road dark, dark brown uniforms. The BG logo on the front, the orange stripes, and the numbers on the back in orange with the name. Miami, those home white uniforms with the red M on the front, the red number on the back with the red name across the top of the back in their uniforms. And the first time the RedHawks have worn those uniforms this year because it is the home opener. So Patrick Geshan and Jack Schmelzinger with you here from Oxford, Ohio tonight. Steve, Cady Arena, so glad you're with us for a huge game and a huge series this weekend for both of these teams, trying to figure out where they are with so many new faces on either side of the red line here tonight. RedHawks move right to left across your radio at period number one, and the game is on from Oxford, Ohio. The Miami RedHawks will dump the puck in here to get us going behind the Falcon net. Such a big student crowd here tonight. The general admittance section is filling up as well. We should have a great atmosphere from Oxford this evening. Falcons with a puck in their own zone. They'll chip it to center ice, but it's taken over by Ryan Savage. Quick entrance into the BG zone. A shot on that is patted away by Rose. The rebound on Chase Pletsky's stick, the left wing circle. That shot is a glove save by Rose to give us our first stoppage. 27 seconds into the first period.
Patrick, I really like that move by Chris Bergeron starting this game with his checking line. That's Chase Pletsky, Red, and Ryan Savage. They're listed as the third line on the game notes tonight, but that is probably the fastest and the most skilled line the RedHawks have. Yeah. I like starting out with them, get some speed in there early.
Draw to the right of Rose. RedHawks win it, working around the blue line. They can't get it deep, though. BG on a rush the other way. It's Barber over the RedHawk line right wing through the circle. A weak wrist shot that's blockered away by Pearson to the far half wall in the Miami zone. RedHawks here in the far circle will grab the puck back. And it's Matt Berry using his legs to get through center ice, throwing the BG line right wing, a play in front, and a hooking call might be coming up here against Bowling Green. And it is, as a centering pass from the right wing circle went in front of the net to Miami's Michael Regish. And he was trying to get a shot off near the crease on Rose, but got hooked from behind. And to the power play for the first time tonight is Miami. 51 seconds into the game, the guilty party for BG is Gabriel Chiquan, the senior defenseman.
Pretty good way to start. The RedHawks had a lot of trouble last weekend with special teams, went 0-for on the power play in Michigan State. Let's see how they do here early in this one.
3-for-17 on the years, Miami, the 22nd best in the nation. They get the draw to start off the man advantage. Puck in the far corner for Barbellini, offensive zone, RedHawks far half wall, a shot in there by Chase Kreisach from the right wing half wall is into the breadbasket of Rose to stop the clock with 18:58 to go in the first period. We have 10 seconds gone by in the power play. Draw coming to Rose's left. You got Regis in it for the RedHawks against Nathan Burke of Bowling Green, their leading scorer. RedHawks win the draw, right point. Kreisach down the far half wall, a backhand pass. Daskey walks in from the line, he scores! No, he didn't. He hit the crossbar with a shot. The mean that looked in, but the referee right there says no, and BG clears for the rebound of that.
Man, that looked really into me, almost positive that got the top netting. Looks like Rose down there knows it too, sitting back in his net looking dejected.
So they might have to review that next whistle. We'll see what they say upstairs. RedHawks on the BG line right away. Ringish can't center it over to Matthew Berry for the right wing circle. BG rips it around from behind their own net all the way back down the ice. Good clearing attempt by Ben Wozny, the defenseman from Richmond, British Columbia.
You can see how fast the RedHawks are moving already tonight. First time in front of fans at Cady Arena.
I know, they're pumped up.
They sure are.
A minute to go on the Miami power play. They're in the offensive zone. RedHawks yard to the far half wall. Clement turned it over there, and a good stick check by Taylor Schneider separated him from the puck. It's Schneider the clear all the way back behind the RedHawk cage and Ludvig Pearson. Dylan Moulton finds Jack Clement. They are at the center ice red line right away. Miami can't get it across the ice, though, into the BG zone, and so Bowling Green grabs control near side of their blue line as Parker sent it all the way back down and behind the RedHawk net. And so Miami here will regroup on the power play with 27 seconds to go in their own end. Dylan Moultz in the rush over the BG line, right wing to the far corner of the offensive zone. He's hit hard there by Lloyd in the far corner. And the RedHawks trying to go back to the point with a pass. It was Cassetti there trying to return to Clement, who was out of position, not on the right point. This puck comes all the way back down to the Miami zone. RedHawks chip it to center. Daly sends it back in from the center ice red line, right wing, and Clement back to pick it up behind his net. The power play time expiring for Miami. Here's Capstick over the BG line, left wing. He's hit hard through the slot there, middle of the ice. Nice check by Anton Malmstrom to knock Capstick off the puck. Back to the right point, Sinard walks it down the far half wall. The play back behind the net to the near corner. Cassetti first to it for Miami. He's pounded against the boards by Daly. Loose puck in the near side of the Miami zone. Falcons will grab it, get it back out to the center ice area where Sinard grabs the turnover, hits P.J. Fletcher with a feed. Over the line right wing, the shot by Olmstead. Rebound, they score! As Cassetti comes in and finishes! And with 16:36 to go in the opening period, Miami finds the scoreboard. And it's Joey Cassetti with his third goal of the year.
What a great play by the RedHawks. A pass to the middle of the ice by P.J. Fletcher. A shot by Jack Olmstead from a dangerous area right in the high slot. Joe Cassetti crashing the net. That shows what happens when you crash the net. Great things happen when you go look for rebounds. Joe Cassetti just found that out.
Found it out big time. Just a quick Miami rush into the zone. Bowling Green on a whole lot of guys back. Fletcher found Olmstead in the middle. His shot at the rim of the right circle. Had a big rebound. After the save by Rose and Cassetti, the wrister, top right corner over his glove side. And it's 1-0 Miami here, finding the scoreboard less than 5 minutes into the first period. So Bowling Green, how do they respond? They're out of their own end, near side of the ice. At the red line, Swangler dumps it in behind the red hot net. Bowling Green, a strong forecheck, trying to work it down there. 2-3, the Falcons take the battle behind the red hot net. Back to the right point, Parker. Middle of the blue line with it there is Gabriel Chiquan for BG, able to trickle it down to the far corner of the Miami zone. Clement finds Stasky in the D-to-D look behind the Miami goal line. They're able to work it out of their zone and up through the center ice red line area where Clement dumps it in behind a Falcon net. Full five-man change for Miami. Red Savage can't pick off a pass near side of the center ice red line against Burke. Red Hawks with it in their own end. It's Drasner. Right wing finds Ryan Savage. Center circle. Left wing feed for Red Savage. Over the BG line. He fired a wrist shot. Tipped off the glove of Rose. Back to the far corner. Miami offensive zone. And BG works it out from there. Back behind the Red Hawk net. 15:22 to go in the first period. 1-0 Miami. The early lead here in game one of the series. Drasner behind the Miami cage. Trying to feed it to Ryan Savage. Right wing in front of the Miami bench. He couldn't really move it forward. Bowling Green takes over in their own end. They'll try to hit Fighton with a pass. Right side of the Miami line. They can't connect. And a nice call here against Bowling Green. 15:07 to go in the first.
Patrick, I don't know about you, but this does not look like the same Miami RedHawks that we saw last year. So fast, so skilled, and always feet moving. Yeah, it's pretty fun to watch so far. Chase Plesky chasing after that puck down in the zone. I mean, I don't know if I've ever seen a human move that fast.
RedHawks with it back in their own end after they lose the draw in the Bowling Green offensive zone. Here come Miami up through center ice. Perry over the BG line, left wing with numbers. He's pinned up against the near half wall. Dishes back to the left point. Capstick couldn't get the feed there. And Bowling Green center ice red line with a dump in. Good one there by Brandon Krieger behind the Red Hawk net. Full five-man change for the Falcons. Red Hawks work this over the BG line, right wing, and a long stretch pass with it down low for Miami. Number 17 in white. As they work this one back behind the net, that was Regas who had it. Now he goes to Barry at the far corner. Barry will run this one around the board to the left point. Daskey with it at the blue line. Down low, a feed to Grisak. He was high stick by Lloyd. Grisak had to abort the mission and grab his head. Therefore, the puck trickled to the far side, and Bowling Green works it out. Maybe a two-on-one the other way. Over the line, left wing with a toe drag move. Brian O'Hara, but the play broken up in the slot as he cut middle. Kind of a one-on-one battle with Daskey. Fletcher now near side of the Miami. Offensive zone, the shot, rebound! He put it in the net, but Rose held onto it for a split second, and they blew the play dead because of that. So Fletcher got a stretch pass from the Miami zone. He went over the BG line on the left wing, fired a shot from the near circle. Rose barely held on to it for what, a second, a half second? Let go of the puck. Fletcher came in and put it past him on a rebound, but Joe Sullivan, the referee, blew the whistle As soon as Rose got the puck and said no goal, then that will be the call that stands on the ice. So we have 14 minutes to go in our first period. The RedHawks up 1-0. The goal by Joey Cassetti is third of the year. We're back in a moment. You're listening to Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio. Minutes to go in our first period. Trot coming up to the right on the BG netminder tonight is Zach Rose. The Miami offensive zone near side of the ice. 1-0 Red Hawks lead it over Bowling Green. Game one of two in this home and home series for Oxford tonight. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger with you on Red Hawk Radio this evening. Glad you're with us. Joey Cassetti in the trot for Miami with Taylor Schneider of Bowling Green. Little false start in the draw. They finally get the puck down. Clean win. Cassetti back to the left point. Traster from Miami dumps it in behind the BG net. It rings around to the far half wall. Moulton pinched in for the right point to keep it in. Puck trickles to the far corner. With it here is Daskus in a one-on-one battle. Pinning against the boards. Able to work it right point. Moulton sends it right back down to the corner behind the net. Here's Fletcher. Here's Circle Miami trying to spin away from the man with him on the puck. Able to get a pass back behind the cage. Rigish. Looking to center to Cassetti. He can't connect there. And here comes BG with a turnover back the other way. Near side feed goes behind Alex Barber, their captain. He'll rim it around the Miami net. Back to the far half wall of the Red Hawks zone where Cassetti turns it over. Barber left point, BG offensive end. Spins it back for Schneider, but he can't get a shot through. Bodies in the far circle. And Cassetti skates it out to the right side of the center ice red line and can't get it deep in the BG end. Falcons were there to block it down. Bowling Green over the line on the right side, Miami zone. Schneider rides Drazner to the corner. They work for the puck there in a two-on-two battle as Cole and Olmstead tie up two. Redhawks win it to the far side. Capstick off the high glass, back to center ice. Barbellini over the line right wing, trying to go past Burke with a puck, but Burke able to get it back to his own man in the far corner, BG zone. That's Ben Wozny, and the Falcons here chip off high glass back to neutral ice. Burke, left side feed at the Red Hawk line. Offside there was Swankler. As he had a man coming in on the rush on the right side of the Red Hawk line at number 14, Cole Norris. 12:38 to go in our first period. Draw coming up, neutral ice. On the Miami right wing closest to their blue line. And a 1-0 lead for the Red Hawks here from Oxford. And this tries Red Savage, but he loses it to Swankler of Bowling Green. Falcons here working it up through neutral ice. There's Miami able to turn the puck over momentarily and they give it back to the BG in their own end. Here's Swankler, near side feed for Lloyd. Back in the near half wall, chips it off the glass, back to center ice. Burke on it, the cross ice feed goes behind the man it was intended for in Malmstrom, who has to chase back to his own zone to get it for BG. Now they're over the line, left wing. Here come the Falcons, pass in front of him, saved by Pearson on a broken rush. Swankler tried to send it through. And Ludwig there with a save. Puck goes to the near corner, Miami zone. BG on it, here's Burke. Trying to work his way in the corner. Red Savage, a nice cross check from behind. We got a call coming up. BG here on the near side. We got another shove down by Daskey on Morris, but they're not gonna call that. It's touched up by Miami at center ice. It BG to the power play for the first time tonight is Red Savage. We'll see what they give him for a call. Probably just a minor coming here. And it's going to be a minor for cross-checking to Red Savage.
Yeah, and kind of a dumb penalty, a young player penalty for sure from Red Savage, the freshman. Just cross-check the guy from behind in the corner. Yeah. That's going to be a penalty every time, any level of hockey. Not something you, Chris Bergeron for sure, will not be happy about that one.
So the power play here to Bowling Green. We have 11:49 to go in the first period. A 1-0 lead for the Red Hawks. Draw coming to Pearson's left features Scardina against Miami's Michael Rigish. Clean win Scardina back to the right point for Lloyd. BG power play this year. That's 1-for-8 in their series against RPI a couple weeks ago. A shot from the left point off the stick of Ryan O'Hara goes off crag stick in front of the net for BG. Up and out of play behind Ludwig Pearson to stop us with 11:42 to go in the first period, 1:52 to go in the power play. It's good to hear a band again.
It sure is. I'm really loving the Miami fight song. I don't even think I heard it last year.
Yeah, you didn't, probably. RedHawks win this draw in their own zone. They clear it all the way back behind the BG net as Rose will stop it for Lloyd. 20 seconds gone by in this BG power play. The Red Savage minor for cross-checking. Puck work back to the near side of the Bowling Green offensive end. Lloyd, right point, slides it over. Left side with a puck at the line. O'Hara back to Lloyd, center blue line. Krieger near circle at a one-time rip, but kind of coughed it up, sent it wide of the net. Far corner Miami zone, BG works the puck to the left point for Lloyd. And a cross-ice feed from him through the blue line goes past Krieger back to center ice. And BG will have to reset with a 1:12 to go on the power play. Lloyd through the center ice area will fire this one in behind the red hot net. Rims it around to the far half wall with it. And Swalman will pass it back to the left point. Here's Taylor Schneider. Far corner with a puck, able to hit a feed to Nathan Burke, who rides it up the far half wall. Moulton got his stick on it there. He's got it pinned up against the boards now in a 2-against-3 battle. Falcons trying to work it free, and they do. Back to the line. Here's Schwankler, center blue line for Shaquan. Far side now with a puck. A wrist shot high above the net goes Schneider. Trickles back to the near half wall for BG. Swankler near circle, back to the line. Shaquan. Far side with a puck, Schneider back to Shaquan, very high slot. He fires one right into the shin pads of Daskus. It trickles back into BGN, and the Falcons here trying to regroup at center ice. 22 to go on the power play. RedHawks really haven't been able to change on this penalty kill. They still got the same four guys out there as BG slowly takes it out of their own end up through the center ice area. Schneider to Burke right from the Miami bench, left wing at the RedHawk line. Burke cannot get into the Miami zone. RedHawks clog the lane, and they work it now right side. Swankler over the RedHawk line right wing. Near circle, Barber, spin around shot. It comes in on Pearson. He makes the cover as soon as penalty time expires. And 9:48 to go in our first period. RedHawks with a great kill there.
And Bowling Green almost looks like they're playing nervous. It's like they can't. It's a, they can't connect on a pass. It's interesting. Miami's putting a lot of pressure on them, and maybe we're seeing Bowling Green's only played two games so far. Miami's played four. Maybe we're seeing a difference here early.
You don't know. 9:48 to go in our first period. RedHawks up 1-0 on Bowling Green. This is Miami Hockey from RedHawk Radio. Just past the halfway point of our first period, RedHawks 1, Bowling Green nothing. A draw coming up to the left of Ludwig Pearson in the Miami zone in our first period. Patrick Getsch, Jack Schmelzinger with you tonight on RedHawk Radio. Thanks for joining us this evening from Oxford. So the faceoff here is won by Miami in their own end. It's Matt Berry taking it behind his net for the RedHawks. Up through the circle near side of the ice. He'll dish it center ice circle to Grisak. It's off his stick into the near corner of the Miami offensive zone. Grisak crashes down there with a few BG Falcons. RedHawks work the puck free in the circle. And bury a rip just over the net on Rose. Close to the far corner. Grisak loses the battle there for the RedHawks. Here comes BG back the other way. On a rush over the center of the blue line. O'Hara for Bowling Green. Trying to drop a pass back for Wozny. He couldn't get a shot off. Kind of fanned on it. And it's Lloyd with it back here in the BGN for the Falcons. Lloyd behind his own net was going to hit the brakes with 9:06 to go in the first period. Works it back up through center ice. Over the line on the right wing, O'Hara dumps it in for a BG into the Miami zone, and it goes to the far corner. Drazner trying to set it up the right wing wall, blocked there by Malmstrom. Momentarily, here comes Bonnie Grant back to the way over the BG line right away, but he was stripped of the puck by the D-man back. That was Barber. And the RedHawks here will have to control it back at their own end as Daschke behind his net feeds it to the far side for Clement in the corner. Up the right wing boards for Sladek. Right side center ice red line for Barbolini. Dumps this one into the far corner in the BG zone. It's ripped around the boards to the left point. Here's Daschke, a shot right into traffic. Sladek picked up the rebound in the slot area, but it went off a body to the near side of the ice. Miami offensive zone still. Far corner, a shot by Clement. Far point, I should say, a shot in by Clement. Goes right into the breadbasket of Rose after Daschke gave him a cross ice feed. 8:19 to go in our first period. So the draw here is coming up to the left of Rose. As we will have Red Savage in it for Miami against Austin Swankler of Bowling Green. And this is a clean win for Miami, but it splits the defenseman at the blue line. Here's Sinard behind the net. Rims it up the near circle of Miami zone. Cross-ice feed was off the stick of Shaquan and high into the stands. And he's trying to go cross-ice there for Miami player up the right wing and Red Savage. So that'll stop play with 8:05 to go in the first period. And a center ice draw is coming up here for Red Savage of Miami and Austin Swankler of Bowling Green. Red Savage able to win this one back in the circle. Redhawks kind of lose control. Both teams fight for it. Finally, BG gets a stick on it. They'll send it back behind the Redhawk net. Rimmed up the near half wall through center ice here on the near side. Bowling Green with a puck. Shaquan sends it around the boards off the stick of Norris. Trickles all the way back down to the Miami zone. They are going to wave the icing off. Is skating evenly with it was Dylan Moulton for Miami. Austin Swankler, Bowling Green. Falcons working right point. Parker the shot in. Off some bodies. Back to the near corner of the Falcon offensive zone. They go back to the line. Parker a slap shot rip over the net on Pearson. Here comes Burke, far corner. Nice hit by Capstick, separates him from the puck. And now Ryan Savage works it off the half wall back to center ice and all the way down. Here's Pletsky, grabs it in the right circle. And a backhand shot goes off the shoulder there of Rose and behind the net. Here come the Redhawks working it back up behind the net as they will get Moulton here with a puck near corner of the ice. Bowling Green sets it, four checkers in. Drazeter trying to ride up against the boards. Brandon Krieger. As they tie up for it here behind the Red Hawk net in the far corner. Daskis with it, skates it up the right wing boards, decides to center it behind PJ Fletcher. Back in the near side of center ice as Coyle rips it around behind the Red Hawk net to the far half wall. Daschke here on the puck. It'll work it back for Daskis. Drazner behind the net for the Red Hawks as it pinned up against the boards behind the cage. They'll try to flip this one free as Daschke was in the area. Now they work it back up to the near wing. Back to the line is Coyle. Far side feed, a shot at the line. Went off a body in front from Wozny's stick. And Daskis will get out the pitching wedge and lob it to center ice all the way down to the BGN for an icing here against Miami with 6:21 to go in the first period. Draw coming up to the right of Ludwig Pearson. .6:20 left in our first period. A shot came in from Bowling Green's Taylor Schneider. Quick face off win. Schneider at the rim of the circle and Pearson able to make the bread basket save. With 6:19 to go in the first period. So the draw here coming up to the right of Pearson again. Regis in it for Miami against Taylor Schneider of Bowling Green. Schneider clean win to himself, the center. And again, the puck right after the draw, kind of fire a weak shot at Pearson. He patted it away. And it was cleared back to center ice. BG rips it around the Miami net again, back to the near corner. Daschke, far side Clement, rims it around the far side boards. Daly can't grab it for BG, a spin around shot as he passes it to his teammate Barber. Top of the far circle, comes in on Pearson, he makes the save with the glove. 5:59 to go in the first period, the play stopped. Draw coming to Pearson's right here in the Miami zone. 1-0 Redhawks, and they lead the shots 8-4. Monty Graham in this draw for Miami against Bowling Green's Austin Swankler. So Swankler with the left-handed stick is going to win this one back to the left point of his zone and back behind the net with it. And it's Monty Graham trying to crash with Swankler with a puck behind the Red Hawk net. It squirts free to the far half wall And to the far corner of the zone. Here comes Norris. Pass to the left point for BG. That's Shaquan. Back to the near side for Kapsik. Off the high glass to center ice. Shaquan, our side of the center ice area, trying to go up for Swankler. And this one is stuck in gear. It's stuck in somebody's gear. It went in the Miami bench. I'm not sure which. I think it went in the Miami bench. 5:30 left in the first period. Drop coming up on the Miami right wing, closest to their blue line. BG wins this center ice draw. Here is Coyle in the near wing for O'Hara. Red Hawks trying to stick it away from him, back in their own end. Moulton, near side of the center ice area for Red Savage. Can't get it to him. Bowling Green, the dump in behind the Miami net. Pearson stops it there for Drasner. Off the far half wall for Ryan Savage. Bounced off his stick back to center. Wazzy there for BG. Turn it back to Ryan Savage. And now the Falcons will get it back in their own end after Savage dumped it in at center ice. With a puck, left wing is Peters. He can't stick it forward. Red Savage gives him a hard hit in front of the Miami bench. Savage and Peters are tied up now in like a fight. We're getting a penalty coming up here. Red Savage went right after Peters. Basically no intention to play the puck. And we will certainly have calls coming up. He just went right after him, started throwing punches almost. So I don't know if they're going to take both of them. I think they will. And with this, we have immediate timeout with 4:55 to go in the first period. We'll sort it all out for you when we come back. You're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. .455 to go in the first period here from Oxford, Ohio. 1-0 lead for Miami over Bowling Green. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger with you after this media timeout. Very physical play there, Jack, in that last sequence. And we talked earlier this week about Bowling Green and Miami, two teams that are hard to play against because they're in your face. And when you have two teams like that playing each other, it really amps up.
Absolutely. And when you don't have the most skilled players in college hockey, you have to do things like that. You have to get in the other team's face. Both of these teams are doing that here tonight, and when that happens, we're going to see some aggression and some people get pretty angry, like we just saw Red Savage and a Bowling Green Falcon get right there.
Yeah, it was Red Savage and Gabriel Shaquan of Bowling Green who just kind of tied up for a little bit, and then Savage really went after Adam Pinners, the junior forward from Grosse Pointe, Michigan. They're both in the box. We have not gotten an official call yet from the referee. Joe Sullivan will announce that now. The ref mic is pretty quiet tonight. So they have two penalties on Red Savage. One of them is an elbow and head contact, and the other one is roughing. They gave Pitters a roughing call.
And was it Pitters who ended up with his helmet off on the ice?
Yes, because Red Savage went right after him and knocked the helmet. I mean, Red Savage didn't even try to play the puck. He just went right after him, tried to start a fight almost.
And we've seen that already tonight, a lot of aggression from Red Savage. Interesting. Yeah. Wonder what the source of that is. I mean, he's a great player, but if he's in the box.
He's a skill guy.
Yeah. If he's in the box, he's not going to be much help.
So it's going to be a Bowling Green power play. Falcons are on it for 2 minutes here. They win this offensive zone draw to the right of Pearson. Swankler with it, right point feeds it middle line for Shaquan, back to the far side for Schneider, back to Shaquan, left point. Near side, Swankler in the circle, far side, Schneider. And a quick shot by him goes through everybody in the slot, back to the right point, BG with it, Shaquan to the near half wall, Swankler, cross his feet, Schneider, left point, on the forehand from the far corner, down low with it, Barber. Back to the line, Shaquan, middle of the blue line, his shot goes off a few sticks, right to Derek Daske of Miami, he'll send it back to center ice. BG quickly regroups over the Red Hawk line again on the right wing. Swankler hits the brakes high in the zone. Nice cross ice look for Barber. Back to the near circle. Swankler center blue line. Shaquan far point with it. Schneider trying to walk down the far half wall. Fletcher ties him up. Swankler's pass in the far circle. Can't connect with Burke. Red Hawks clear for that. Back to center ice with 106 to go on the power play for Bowling Green. Barber trying to send it over the Red Hawk line right wing. Can't do it. And Swankler now with it. Right side of the red line at center ice. Red Hawks able to send this off of his stick back down to their own zone. As Bowling Green with it behind their net as Lloyd has the puck for BG. 3:40 left in the first period. Lloyd, the far side feed on the stick of Krieger, rims it around the boards behind Pearson, the Miami net. Pearson leaves it there for the Red Hawks, Chase Kreisach, and he'll rip this one around the boards behind the Bowling Green net. Now with the puck is TJ Lloyd. 30 to go on the BG power play. Lloyd in the left wing feed with it over the line on the left side for the Falcons. That's Ryan O'Hara. Back down low, open look here for Craggs in a play in front. Couldn't connect with Lloyd. It was coming down the middle. The puck trickles to the far corner. With it there for BG is Scardina. He won the race. Far half wall, O'Hara back to Scardina. Far side with 8 to go on the power play. Lloyd in the near circle. Krieger back to Lloyd. A bomb from the center of the blue line. Nice blocker saved by Pearson, and here comes Miami with a power play expiring. Over the line right away, Kreisach, the centering play to Pletsky went over his stick. Here's Sladek near corner for the Red Hawks. Pinned up against the boards by Krieger of Bowling Green. Graham wins the puck away in the battle. Sladek now with it. Miami offensive zone far corner. Met to the boards by Bowling Green's Craggs, and then Craggs works this one out back to center ice and all the way down into the Red Hawks zone. At 2:30 to go in the first period, we're 5-on-5. Capstick out of his own end with a puck for Miami. Up the near wing boards through center ice. Daskis with it in the near corner of the BG zone as the Falcons work it free from him and over to the far corner. Here's Schneider. Finds a pass to Schneider over the line left wing. As it was Spencer Schneider going to Taylor Schneider. Schneider, they're brothers. And the puck here in the Miami zone far half wall. With it is Cassetti right wing at the red line. Will dump it in for Ben Wozny, far side of the BG zone. He lifted it out to center and was hit hard. We got a call coming here on that. As he was hit by one of the Red Hawks down there, he couldn't make out who it was. On the far half wall of the BG zone, that hit came in well after Wozny got rid of the puck, clearing it out to center ice. And right back in the box go the Red Hawks as Cassetti picks up a minor for roughing with 1:57 to go in the first period.
I'm almost excited to see this Miami power or penalty kill work again. They are really playing aggressively. As soon as a BG player gets the puck in Miami's defensive zone, a Red Hawk is right out to him.
Yeah.
And you don't see that. You don't see teams do that against power plays that they really respect much.
Right.
You can see that the Red Hawks do not expect much from this Bowling Green power play.
Bowling Green wins it to the far half wall of their offensive zone. Swankler near circle. A little shot, I guess you could say, in front. As Alex Barber trying to come through and grab it, hopped over his stick right to Pearson, who made the save with a glove on the ice. 8 seconds gone by in this power play for BG. Again, 1:48 to go in the first period.
Doesn't it feel like Derek Daske has been on the ice for about 17 minutes
so
far this period?
Yeah, feels like it.
A lot of injuries on that Miami defensive core.
They are banged up for sure. Red Hawks clear this one after the faceoff win in their own end. So with it behind his net is Shaquan for BG. Fires it over left side for Taylor Schneider. They're over the Red Hawk line right wing. Swankler back to the line for Barber in the slot. A high wrist shot over the net off the glass. It comes back in front. Burke can't get a stick on it for another try. And it goes to the left point here in the BG offensive end. Near side of feed for Swankler. Top of the near circle. And a pass there goes off a body. That was Regish, his stick. And out to center ice with 1:16 to go in the BG power play. 1:10 to go in the first period. Barber in his own end for Bowling Green. Spins around from a man. Will flip this one in. Cross corner to the far side of the Miami zone. With it is Barbellini in the corner. Trying to get tied up there with O'Hara. O'Hara steals the puck away. Swankler top of the near circle. Back to the center ice area near the center of the blue line. Lloyd, far side, a stick shatters there on a shot by O'Hara. Here comes Miami back to the way as Moulton got hit hard in front of his own bench, turned it over. And Swankler coming over the Red Hawk line, right wing on a pass. Swankler jumped ahead of the blue line before the puck came through. And the play stopped on the BG offside, 42.1 to go in the first period, and 46 seconds left in the BG power play.
Man, that was a funny play. I forget who it was for BG, trying to take a shot, and just the stick failed him. Flew all the way up in the air, almost over the glass.
I've never seen it that. I've never seen that. On a wrist shot.
It was, interesting.
Neutralized draw, one by Bowling Green, back to their own end. Here's Lloyd with it behind his net. Hits the brakes, takes a breath. And now it's back up the right wing. Here's Scardina, gets a pass over the Red Hawk line, rushes into the zone, chases a loose puck to the near corner. With it there is Moulton to meet Scardina with a puck. They tie up for it. Behind the net is cracked for Bowling Green in the far corner. Back to the line for Lloyd, center of the blue line. Near circle down the feed, down low. This is Krieger. We'll go to cracked behind the Red Hawk net. It trickles to the far half wall. O'Hara sends it down to the far corner. Miss Scardina's stick. Back to the near side of the ice for Krieger. He'll leave it there for Sam Craggs to the line. Lloyd will fire it near circle. Craggs trying to calm down a bouncing puck as time expires in the first period. And the Red Hawks penalty kill really doing the job, Jack. They'll have three more seconds of Bowling Green power play time to take care of when we start the second period. But after 20 minutes, I think you're thinking good things if you're Miami up 1-0.
Absolutely. They've been flying all over the ice so far. They look fast, they look skilled, and they look angry.
Yeah.
They look excited to be here. The neutral zone trap has been as good as I've seen it since I've been watching Miami hockey. Bowling Green cannot get anything going in the neutral zone. They cannot get the puck up into Miami's offensive zone very well. So overall, a really good first period, I would say, from the Red Hawks.
I like the word angry, and I agree with you, because they came out with some grit and some fire tonight. And to me, it's something we really didn't see at Fair State, really didn't see at Michigan State. The entire goal of rebuilding this program is to make them a team like that, with fire and with some anger in their game. It's so good we're seeing that here tonight on the ice between Miami and Bowling Green, and two teams as well. I mean, look at the Bowling Green power play, very ineffective there in that first period. They really need to get that going if they want to try to have some success this weekend.
Yeah, and like I said, the Miami penalty kill is really flying out to those Bowling Green puck carriers. And it's almost like they're not worried about them making a tape-to-tape pass. And from what we've seen, it looks like they don't have to be, because they haven't made a tape-to-tape pass on the power play all game.
I know. Shots on goal here after our first 20 minutes of play in favor of Miami, 8-6. The power play, Bowling Green 0-2 on the power play in that first period. Miami was 0-1. Faceoffs led by the Red Hawks, 11-10 thus far. Miami with 8 blocked shots to Bowling Green's 3. And the penalty minute count led by Miami 8-4. At this point in the hockey game, and the Red Hawks lead the column that it counts most. 1-0 in the goal column here at our first intermission from Oxford. The synchronized skating team performing on the ice right now.
You can probably hear the music. They're pretty impressive, I gotta say.
Yeah. They've won like 13 straight national championships.
That's right.
It's kind of crazy at this point. For them. Let's take a look at our NCHC out-of-town scoreboard while we have a moment. Just getting our first intermission started here. In Boston tonight, Colorado College is visiting Boston College. The Tigers of Colorado College lead at 1-0. They are through a period of play in Chestnut Hill. Denver and Providence are scoreless after a period in their game in Providence. North Dakota 1, Quinnipiac 1 after the first period in Connecticut. Look at all these NCHC teams are playing out east this weekend. 1-0 in our game, and that is it for the NCHC slate here this evening. All right, so after the first period, it's so good to have a crowd back. That's number one. It's so good to have a band back, and it just feels normal here.
Yeah, it's awesome. As a sophomore, I have never experienced Cady Arena like this. It is so exciting. Just walking into the arena today around 6 o'clock, an hour before game time, you could feel the atmosphere in here was crazy. There's already people lined up to get in. I mean, it was really exciting, really a fun atmosphere here in Oxford, Ohio tonight.
And pretty much every seat you see is filled, which is great, especially in the student section and the general admittance crowd as well. So that's excellent to see, because it really hasn't been like that the past few years, even before COVID started. So it's so good to see people back in this building getting an atmosphere, and they hope to see a Miami win here this evening. So we have about a 12-minute break before our
second period begins, and the RedHawks will try to defend their lead when they come back out on the ice in about 12 minutes or so. Join us then. Until then, our first intermission here from Oxford, and this is Miami Hockey on RedHawk Radio. Teams are back out on the ice ahead of our second period of play here from Oxford, Ohio. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger with you from Steve Cady Arena here tonight. On the second period that will begin with a Miami 1-0 lead. There's 3 seconds left and a minor penalty to Joey Cassetti that the RedHawks will have to kill off when we begin the second period, but that will pretty much be no problem at all. As really nothing you can do with 3 seconds of power play time in the game to start off the period. So the fresh ice, RedHawks move left to right across your radio here in the second as Cassetti will exit the box as soon as the puck is dropped. RedHawks lead the shots in that first period, 8-6 over Bowling Green. Daskus and Scardina in the center ice shots, one back by Bowling Green. In their own end, they'll work it up the far wing boards as the penalty expires to Cassetti. You get a whistle here? I thought I heard a whistle, but nobody was stopping. We do have a whistle by the back referee as the RedHawks were moving the puck up through the neutral zone, trying to go in the BG zone. It was a hand pass, maybe? I have no idea. Didn't see a call. So it's going to be a neutralized draw. Miami left wing closest to their blue line is Daskus in it against Scardina. Clean win Scardina for Bowling Green back to the neutral zone. TJ Lloyd is on it here. We'll run it around the boards to the near wing. Back to the near half wall where Clement able to stick it free there from the stick of Krieger. Goes back behind the red hot cage. Daskus for Clement. Now it's Daskus up the far half wall Miami zone. Cassetti can't stick it out. Loose puck here in the far circle. Daskus works it back to the near side for Clement. We'll bomb this one back to center ice and into the BG zone. Wallstrom with it there. Trying to play it up the left wing side at center ice. RedHawks will meet the puck, trying to work it back in the BGN. And the Falcons go D-to-D. And it's lifted out with a 9-iron by TJ Lloyd to center ice. Malmstrom here in the center ice circle. Back to TJ Lloyd in his own end for BG. They work the puck back up the left wing at the red line. RedHawks turn it over. And they're on the BG line. Cassetti through the far circle. Can't center a pass. Back in front of the net. And it's poked to the far half. We'll get a whistle here for a penalty?
I don't know either. Seems like they're just blowing at anything right now. Yeah.
I think it is a penalty here against Cassetti, maybe. They never did make a call, though. So hook against Cassetti. So I didn't see that happen, did you?
I didn't see it. It must have been behind the play, I guess, which Bergeron will not be happy about that. Penalties away from the player, never a good thing.
It's the fourth minor penalty against Miami in the hockey game. They have to kill another one here. 18:56 to go in the first period. It was Cassetti who got that penalty late in the first period. Started the second in the box for 3 seconds, so he goes right back in about a minute later.
Didn't even realize that. Him and Red Savage are really running up the numbers today, though.
Bowling Green wins the draw in the offensive zone. Schneider top of the near circle, down low. They try to feed it in front off the stick of Barber. That didn't work. Miami clears it all the way down the ice from the near circle, their own zone.
And all jokes aside, this penalty kill is only going to hold up for so long. Miami has to be a lot more disciplined for the rest of the game.
You don't want to do this to yourself against NCHC teams.
Exactly.
Coming in here to play. BG works the puck far corner of the Miami zone. Back to the near side for Schneider. Works it up the left wing wall, trying to go back to the left point. Escape the stick, though, of Burke. And he'll have to take it back to center ice with the Falcons. Burke through the center circle of the Red Hawk line left wing, moving his feet, trying to skate it down to the far corner. Drasner meets him there, knocks him over. They don't call it. And it goes back to the far half. We'll hear the BG offensive end. Swankler spins around for Rigish. Walks it down the half wall, pass back to the line for Shaquan. Over the near corner, far circle, a big rip there by Swankler. The rebound by Pearson went to the near circle and it was sent wide by Schneider. Another shot from the line, another rebound in front. Pearson, two saves on the Falcons. Bowling Green with it, very high slot. Back to the near circle with it is Schneider. His shot goes off Drasner's skates. Schneider works it back to the far circle. Swankler in front, another save by Pearson. On a wrist shot there. Here's Schneider back to the line for Shaquan. Far circle with a putt goes Swankler. Shaquan to the near side for Schneider. 28 to go in the power play. Schneider down low for Barber. Three times to try to whack it. Five hole at Pearson. As he got the pass at the right post, worked it in front, tried to stub it through Pearson's legs, but he was right there to squeeze him shut. And the clock stopped with 17:19 to go in the second. 24 seconds left in the power play.
And we're starting to see that this Bowling Green power play is getting a little bit more comfortable here. They're moving the puck around. They are tape to tape now, really moving the puck around this Miami penalty kill. And as we said, Miami's going to have to be a lot more disciplined. Bowling Green is looking like they're starting to figure it out.
I think so. Well, when you had the power play for four times in a game, yeah, you got to improve a little bit.
At some point, yeah, it's like practice almost.
Draw here to Pearson's right. RedHawks win in their own corner. Clement gets shoved out from behind there. The arms will stay down. Three against three battle here as Clement just locks his puck up with his skate against the boards. And nobody's able to dig it free. You get Crags and Wallstrom down there for B&G to try to shovel it. Finally, it squirts free in the near circle. Barbellini overskated it for Miami. Now Scandina hits Graham hard. We got two arms up by each referee as penalties are coming here. Cassetti escapes from the box. He's going to chase a puck that was set down the ice in the BG zone by a Red Hawk player. I think it was Savage, Red Savage. Nonetheless, that's an icing call against Miami. So we had about five weird hits in the near corner of the Miami zone when this battle was going on. The students were going nuts. And once that happens, guys start to get a little more chippy. It's going to be a holding penalty ultimately against Bowling Green. So must have been some holding going on when someone is trying to skate to a puck. You really didn't see what happened. Sam Craggs, number 25, in the brown uniform, is going to head to the box. Red Hawks to the power play for the second time in the hockey game, and they are 0-1 in that department here tonight.
No love lost between these teams. You can tell that the Red Hawks and the Falcons have not forgotten how much they dislike each other since 2019,
right,
the last time they played.
This is a rivalry.
Yes, sir.
Daschke far side, Barry, a rip from the circle, went off a body in front, deflected to the near side, and is kicked to center ice. Bowling Green does it a clear, 1:48 to go on the power play. Rigas over the BG line right away for Grisak, back down to the corner for Rigas. Works it behind the goal line, and in the end, Barbellini just ate up. A big hit by him on Norris, who's down. Redhawks is shot for the line, and he can't get it in the net as Barry that time at a second try. Norris finally gets up. In the far corner is BG, a weak clear to center ice. Redhawks going to work this right back in. Grisak over the BG line right away. And the drop pass for Barry. Top of the near circle. Far side feed for Pletzky, who could slide it in front. And Bowling Green turns it over in their own end momentarily. Miami a mishandle on the puck. And it's back at center ice. Quickly over the BG line left wing. Barbellini through the circle. Can't feed it forward on his centering feed. Redhawks work it back at the line. Grisak walks in far circle. Down low Barbellini. Back to the line for Daschke, left point. Near side for Matthew Barry. Works into the far point now. Daschke, center blue line, top of the near circle. Grisak, a pass in front, right in front of the net, but Barbellini mishandled it and went off his stick to the near half wall. Daschke slides in there to keep it in the zone. Grisak with it with 43 to go on the power play. Near circle to drop back. Daschke to the far side. Barbellini trying to go be a hero and centered in front through the slot. Went off the stick of Schneider and BG, the easy clear back down the ice.
Yeah, and be a hero is right. Miami just looking for the perfect shot there. You can't always do that. Sometimes you just have to put the puck on net on the penalty, or on the power play, rather.
22 to go on the power play. Moulton to Drasner, rips it around the boards from the BG line. Left wing works itself to the near half wall, past Fletcher, and back to center ice where Moulton will go D-to-D for Drasner again, now in the Miami zone. 8 seconds left to the Red Hawk advantage. Fletcher cross ice feed. Trying to go over the BG line, left wing Daskus. He mishandled it. Moulton coming in to rescue him, but then it was stolen away from him and kicked back in the Miami zone. Drazner with it behind the Red Hawk net. Will chase back for it. Through the near circle, trying to get it out of the zone, but can't. Red Hawks still have reinforcements in their own end, and they'll go to the far side in the left wing of their own zone where Moulton dishes back for Drazner. That pass can't connect. In the far circle, the Red Hawks zone as BG was changing all five guys, luckily for Miami. They'll work it out to center ice. Fletcher over the BG line, right wing. We'll get it down low to the corner. Coyle first to it for the Falcons. Now Wozni has it turned over off his stick by Cassetti. The puck bouncing behind the BG cage. Falcons work it up the left wing. The cross ice play to the far side where Capstick picks it up. Left side of the center ice red line to dump it in behind the Falcon net. BG works it up through center ice. Throw the Red Hawk line left wing. Schneider passes it in front. The centering feed behind Pitters. And here comes Miami 2-on-2. Brett Savage lost it over the BG line right away. Kick to center ice. Where Sinard will walk his puck back to his own end for Miami. The feed in front through center ice for Pletsky. Went off his dip. Back to the BG line. Here's middle of the red line center ice. Schneider gives it back over to Pletsky, who's over the BG line left wing. Pletsky has shot. Big save, big rebound in front. Ryan Savage can't get it. Another try. Deskis scores! Never mind, it was Capstick who came in and finished it on a flurried play in front. And the Red Hawks take a 2-0 lead as Alec Capstick will get his fourth career goal and first of the season.
What a nasty goal by the Red Hawks.
Wow.
Playing nasty tonight. Puck in front of the net and everyone crashing. I think there might have been five guys in the slot there for the puck. I'm sure there probably weren't, but it looked like there were. As we said earlier, good things happen when you crash the net. Go back, go in for rebounds.
Yeah. Bigger part is Capstick who came in to finish it off instead of Daskis. As the Red Hawks score there. They're going to review this, I believe. For what reason, I don't know, but the referees are in the box.
I guess it's got to be goalie interference, right?
Yeah. There was just a flurry going on in front, and it was hard to describe it all happening at the same time. And that puck kind of kicked free. Well, Rose was trying to come out and make the save, the BG goaltender. He was out about 2 feet past the crease.
Right.
Near the hatch
yeah,
marks
right.
Almost. And so there's obviously bodies in that area, traffic messing with him. Now, when you're out of the blue paint, you're free game pretty much if you're
right.
A netminder.
Absolutely.
The blue paint is your safe area, and that's when Capstick was able to slide it five-hole through Rose when he was trying to scamper his way back to the net after escaping the blue paint. So Joe Sullivan has our call. It's a good goal. And a very quick video review there.
Nothing wrong with going in and taking a look, right?
No, as long as it's quick.
Yeah, that's for sure.
2-0 Miami, 13:31 to go in the second period. Good for Alec Capstick, his first goal of the year. For the defenseman out of Langley, British Columbia. Center ice draw one by Miami. They send it though in the BG bench. As Daskey got a hold of it in his own end, trying to fire it up the left wing. So we get a media timeout here with 13:26 to go in the second period. Following that play, 2-0 Red Hawks are on top of Bowling Green. And you're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. T26 to go in our second period of the timeout. Draw to the left of Ludwig Pearson here in the Miami zone. It is a clean win back for Bowling Green, and Wacky it down from the right point. TJ Lloyd trying to go a wraparound from the far side of Pearson. That couldn't quite work. Didn't have the leverage there, and it's back behind the BG offensive net. Krieger centers it to the far side. They score! It went to the far circle, and there to finish it with a wrist shot, Scardina. And Ethan Scardina sent the puck through traffic. It beat Pearson on his glove side. I don't think Ludwig even saw it. That pass came from the near post of the net to the far circle. Scardina finishes it off for Bowling Green for his second goal of the year.
Yeah, I'm not sure that it was Derek Dashke, but I think it might have been Derek Dashke. A pretty bad turnover there behind the net. Puck squirts out in front right to the slot. And Scardina did not make a mistake with that one. Put it right in the net.
2-1 to Miami lead now with 13 to go in the second period. Puck is in the Bowling Green zone, far corner. Falcons here are trying to work it out behind their net. Pass to the near wing. Misses. Sam Craggs went behind him. Sennard back with it at center ice for the RedHawks. Dumps it over the BG line left wing. Here's Grisak. Far corner of the puck for Miami. Trying to work this one up the far half wall. Does so. Finds Capstick. Walking in from the left point but can never get a shot off. Going through traffic. Schneider takes a big hit from Capstick going after the puck far half wall. RedHawks get it back. Capstick center. Blue line. A high wrister goes over the net. And Barry picks it up from behind the cage. Barry far half wall for Miami, trying to work this one deep in the zone. It was picked off though by Craig's glove of Bowling Green. They work it to center ice, but a turnover by Rigic. Grisak far circle offensive zone. A nice wrist shot there. Who's off the glove of Rose. He'll make the cover with 12:14 to go in the second period. As the RedHawks, a great forecheck tonight, Jack, and they're being aggressive in the offensive end.
Yeah, they sure are. This is something that we haven't seen from Miami hockey, at least last year. Last year, we certainly didn't see it. It looks like Chris Bergeron is starting to see his vision sort of take shape. These guys are really moving fast. We've been saying it all night. They're playing tenacious. The forecheck is probably where you're seeing that the most.
Drop to the right of Rose. 12:14 to go in the second period. Cassetti in it for Miami. He'll take on number 12 in Brown in this draw in Austin Swankler. Clean win Swankler, Bowling Green from the far corner, working out to center off the high glass. Over the Red Hawk line is Norris, right wing. The pass though, trying to center it, went behind the man. Daskis in the center circle for Miami to the far corner for Cassetti. And the offensive end, kind of a broken play there. Bowling Green will try to work it out here in their own zone. It's back to center ice. Bolton grabs it for the Red Hawks, gave it up for Fletcher. He's over the BG line, left wing. Near circle pass for Daskis, the centering play in front, off a stick. Over the stick of Cassetti, the intended target. BG over the Miami line, left wing Norris. The centering play in front, it went off the stick of Max Coyle in the near circle. The zone trickle to the corner. Bowling Green works it back to the line. Lloyd, a bomb from there. Went just past the left post, wide of the net. Here's Daskis for the RedHawks through center ice. Chips it over the BG line on the right wing. Lloyd with it here in the near corner for the Falcons. Able to pick it up as Miami in a change. 11:20 to go in the second period. Back to center ice, Bowling Green with a puck. They turn it over to Daskey in his zone end. Derek will find Pletsky. Left side of the center ice red line. Chase Pletsky skates it over the BG line here on the left wing. Hit the brakes at the half wall. Spun it back to the line. Brian Savage, a shot from there. Blocker saved by Rose. Kicks it to the far corner. Red Savage picks the puck there on the rebound. Able to work it up the far half wall. Hit the brakes at the hash marks. Now walks it back behind the BG net. Coil of an effective body check to shove him off the puck. And it's Krieger with it here as Bowling Green works it over the Red Hawk line right away. A weird shot came in there by Scardina to the near corner. Now it's Red Savage at center ice. It's Daskey joining the rush over the line of the left wing. The drop pass in the far circle. Missed everybody. No communication there. Was blind. And Bowling Green now with it in their own zone. Some time here with the puck. Daly works it out to center ice. Krieger over the Red Hawk line left wing through the circle. Hits the brakes in the corner. Trying to spin it back up high in the zone. It's turned over though. Ryan Savage works with Daly to get the puck up through center ice. It goes in over the BG line on the right wing onside. Just kind of trickled there into the zone. Ryan Savage far corner for Daskey. Lifts it to open space near side of the Miami offensive end at the half wall. Daly can't shove it up there. And it goes back behind the net to the far side. Here's Capstick, turned it over at the line. Near circle of feet off the skate of Barbellini in the near corner. And he'll walk this one back behind the BG net. Daly pins him up against the boards with 9:48 to go in the second period. Back to the line is Capstick. Sennard right point, a shot through traffic. Good job by Rose. Made an initial save, unintentionally you could tell, with a breadbasket. The rebound popped in front of him and he made the cover with 9:42 to go in the second period.
I've actually really liked what I've seen from Alec Katznik tonight. He stood out. He obviously had the goal, but he's been all over the ice making plays on the puck, playing really good defense on the puck and off the puck. A really, really impressive showing tonight from the junior from Langley, British Columbia.
Yeah, he's been impressive so far tonight. Scored his first goal of the season, I should say, too, and it'll give Miami the 2-1 lead with 9:42 to go in the second period. We'll step aside, quick break. You're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. To go in our second period, 2-1 Miami over Bowling Green. Right here coming up to the right of Zach Rose in the BG net. The clean win for Bowling Green as Schneider worked it back to the near side for Craggs, and they escaped the zone. Passed over the Red Hawk line right wing. It missed the man it was intended for, and Alex Barber. He's got it though in the near corner, works it back behind the Red Hawk net. Stripped away though by Sinard. Schneider trying to work to get it back, finds Barber in the corner, the pass to the near circle off Cragstick, and back to the line. Jaquan keeps it in for BG. Near corner, Schneider trying to throw it through that near circle, went off of Miami skate, and is cleared all the way down the ice by Sinard. To the BG end, Redhawks a five-man long change here in the second period. And Bowling Green trying to work it up the right wing from their own end, a pass to Barber at the Red Hawk line right side. Went off of his stick and into the crowd. Trying to get the crowd fired up here. We got a center ice throughout coming up. 9:06 to go in the second period.
And Patrick, this is not like the football games. We have not seen the crowd thin out whatsoever. Everyone's still
here. I know,
here.
It's good.
Beautiful.
Moulton for Miami with a faceoff win in their own end. Trying to work it up the left wing boards. Back it to the BG zone. And the Falcons here at 2-on-1 the other way. Schneider over the line right wing. And the circle is shot. Big rebound in front of the... A second shot on the rebound after it went off the left pad of Pearson was sent wide of the net by Norris. Here comes Miami back over the BG line right away. Grisak drop pass Barry to the line. Trasner right point purposely wide on the ice. Goes behind the net. Lloyd rims it around to the left point for Moulton, who sends it into the zone on the far corner. Went off a stick. Loose puck there picked up by Bowling Green. They turn it over on the circle. Grisak sent it wide. Barry on the other side of the net. Got it off the end boards. His pass went past everybody there in the slot. Redhawks still work it back near circle. Grisak a rip wide and left of the net. Here comes Norris with a puck though for BG. We'll work it out of the zone back to center ice. Norris with it here through the circle. We'll lift it back into the near corner of the zone of Miami. Drazer rims it up against the boards here on the near side of the ice. Bowling Green comes in and take it away. Scardina through the circle, drive to the net, and Pearson made a bad save on a forehand backhand chance. Centering pass, Gardino missed everybody. Shaquan comes in, left point to rip it wide of the net on the ice. Rimmed around the boards there by Parker, sent to the near half wall of the zone. The Miami zone, Bowling Green, just some miscommunication in the offensive end. They turn it over. Barry over the BG line right away, through the near circle, waits for reinforcements to come in off the bench. Here's Clement walking through the right circle, a wrist shot wide and over the net. And Bowling Green with it behind their cage, trying to work it out. But it's turned over. Quick chance in front for Daskis. Got a nice pass right there at the bottom of the far circle, but ripped a shot that was saved by Rose. And then Clement from the right point. A wrist shot there off Fletcher's stick. Up and out of play with 7:14 to go in the second period. And this offensive zone, forecheck and puck handling by Miami on point tonight.
I mean, it's crazy. They're just... The last few shots they've taken haven't actually hit the net,
yeah.
But they're taking high-danger shots, and it's pretty cool. They're getting a lot of good shots off, and if they ever can start aiming them well, it's going to be a pretty good offense here in Miami.
Draw to the left of Rose is one back by Bowling Green. They'll work it out to center ice, back down to the Miami end as Clement picks it up. Our circle, the near wing feed off Daskis stick to the center ice circle. Off the stick of Cassetti, turned it over to O'Hara. Trying to work it over the Red Hawk line, right wing. Bowling Green kicked back to center, though, after the attempt to get it off the boards, went off the linesman. Now Miami in the offensive zone. Fletcher, far circle. Dishes back to the left point for Daski. Here's Clement, right point. And his pass to the far circle is off a stick. Cassetti picks it up in the corner. Daski's got it there to the far point for Daski. His shot explodes the stick of Daski, and it goes back to center ice. BGM to clear it. You know, over the line on the right wing. A shot in there off the pads of Pearson by O'Hara. Kick back behind the net to the near corner, where Cassetti ties up with Bowling Green Spencer Schneider as they fight for it here up to the left point for Malmstrom. Works it around the boards to the far side. Chip there by O'Hara, top of the far circle, Pitters. Gave it up for Cassetti. Now Clement works it behind the net for Sennard with 6:08 to go in the second period. 2-1 Miami leads Bowling Green here in Oxford. Clement just got blown up on the far half wall. The puck stolen away from him by Sam Craggs, who then took it right to the net. And Pearson was there on the left post to make a save, as Craggs really never got a shot off. It just kind of came in on him off Craggs' stick. And it stops the clock with 6:03 to go in the second.
Something that I've noticed so far is how quick Miami is getting out in transition. As soon as they have a chance to look up ice and move the puck up from their defensive zone, they are getting it up really quick. That's helping them out a lot, getting in front of this Bowling Green defense before they have a chance to really get set back there.
Draw to the left of Pearson. Sennard picks it up in the far corner, and he's going to rim this one all the way down the ice. Easy call here for the officials. Icing against Miami with 5:52 to go here in the second. Miami leading the shot 16-14 in this game. It's closer really on the scoreboard than it seems on the ice to me.
For sure, yeah. It seems like Miami's been down in Bowling Green zone the entire game. I totally agree. 16-14, Miami's favorite in shots. I would have said it was a lot more.
Yeah. Puck out to center ice. Redhawks won the draw on their own end. Ryan Savage with it. Dances his way through the far circle. Drive to the net. And then puck off his stick last second. Just came off there. Barber picked it up for BG. It's Craggs with a pass at center ice over the Red Hawk line right wing. Far circle shot, and it goes off Moulton. He made a nice block. BG kicks it back to the line. Here's Shaquan, left point, into the slot. Barber will rim this one back behind the net for Taylor Schneider. Schneider back in front for Barber, trying to shovel his way to the slot. Nobody there, though, really to get the pass for BG as it went behind Barber. And the butt kick here to the far half wall. To the line, a shot in there by Parker. Went off Ryan Savage, high slot, passes to Red Savage. Over the BG line here on the left wing, kicked off his stick. Pletsky couldn't grab it there, and a breakaway here. Down the wing for Bowling Green, a shot, a rebound, nice save by Pearson. That was Swankler who got the pass. He made two big saves. Pearson made two big saves on Swankler. The first one, a wrist shot, went off Pearson's pad. He picked up the rebound. Pearson made another one with his chest.
How nice is it to have him back there?
Barbellini near corner of the Miami offensive zone. Gave it up for John Sladek. Far corner. Sladek taking a tour there below the goal line. Now he's up the far half wall. Finds Clement, right point. A wrist her in. Goes off of the glove of Rose to the far side. Another shot came in for the line there by Daski. Rebound picked up by a Falcon stick. Sit down the ice. Swankler in the near circle will score as he got a mini breakaway in his offensive zone. Pearson came out trying to play the puck. It was one of those that either guy could have got it. It ended up going to Austin Swankler's stick, and he had a wide open net as Pearson came out of the cage in the near circle. Bowling Green has tied the game at 2 with 4:15 to go in the second period.
What I don't get is how did Swankler get so far behind defense? And it was Andrew Sennard over there for Miami. Looked like he was really hardly even skating on his way back. He might have just known that he was beat, but either way, maybe a little more effort would have been nice.
He just kind of came away from everybody in that Miami offensive zone.
Just got lost back there.
Yeah. And then Pearson made the judgment call to come out and play it, as it was kind of a contested puck in that near circle the way it was sitting there. Swankler got to it first and had a wide open net to shoot at as Pearson came out to that near circle and was inside of it when the shot came in. So we're tied at 2. After Miami led this game 2-0. Over the Red Hawk line is Wozny on the left wing through the circle. His shot off a stick. That was Capstick who blocked it. Deflects to the far half wall. Bowling Green here will try to keep it in the offensive zone. Red Hawks still able to work it out. Nice clearing attempt by Grisak. Back down to the BGN, but it's no icing as Wozny beat it back for the Falcons. He'll send it up the left wing through center ice. Karisak steals it there for Miami. They're over the line on the right wing. Daskus in the near circle, fired a shot. Chest save Rose. Butt kick to the near corner, and it's Coyle with it here for BG. Coyle, as Daskus stripped him of the puck below the goal line in the BG end. Now with it is Grisak. Far half wall, Barry picks it up to the corner. Works it up that far half wall. He's going to find Drazer, right point. Back to Barry, left point, a shot on the ice. Big rebound as Rose made a pad save. It's back to the line, and Rose is down as he was knocked in too hard by about three players. Two of them were Bowling Green players. Another one, I believe, was Grisak, who came in going for that rebound, and Rose just got trucked over, absolutely trucked. And he's down, and the fans booing, but I think Rose has a decent excuse here to be shaken up with 3:02 to go in the second period.
Yeah, that was a big crash in front of the net. I'm not really sure how it happened. Not Miami's fault. It was the Bowling Green guys who I think ended up initiating the contact there, but really not good. Never want to see your goalie get run into by your own players,
no.
That's for sure.
So immediate timeout. We'll give Rose a chance to shake it off. Gerard coming to his right when we come back. 3:02 to go in the second. Tied at 2, Miami and Bowling Green, and this is Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. .302 to go in our second period. Miami 2, Bowling Green 2. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with the air at Steve Cady Arena in Oxford. A 2-0 Miami lead at one point in this game, but Bowling Green 2 second period goals to tie it up. And a draw to the right here of Rose in the BGN. Schneider against Cassetti. They tie up for in the circle. Cassetti for Miami comes away with a win, but stripped free of him by Barber. Barber the feed through center ice, coming over the line on the left wing with a puck. TJ Lloyd for Bowling Green in the offensive zone. A bad angle shot for the corner. A blocker saved by Pearson. The puck on the ice. Dylan Moulton with it near corner now in the Miami zone. Is going to work this one with his legs. Skates it to center ice. Over the line of the left wing. The pass to Cassetti. Trying to go back in front for Moulton. That connection could not work. Drazer right point. Miami offensive zone. Daskus down low. Looking to center. It went off the right pad of Rose. Maybe a shot attempt there instead. And Bowling Green works it back to center ice. Schneider gave it up to Moulton behind the Miami net. Drazner with it now near corner. He copped it up. Schneider's stolen away from him. Schneider drives to the net. Now takes it behind. Pass in front. St. Pearson on a one-time chance. It's loose as they fight for it in the crease. And Ludwig still there to cover it up with 2:08 to go in the second period. That shot came in from Cole Norris. He got the feed from behind the net. Somehow Pearson saw it through the traffic.
Yeah.
He made the save with 2:08 to go in the second.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. I can't believe that he saw that puck. I think he had three or four guys between him and it. Really impressive job from the Swede, and I guess what else would you expect at this point? He's sick.
Sick. Throw out of his right here. Major Schneider against Miami's Red Savage in the circle. I'm sorry, that's Swankler in there for Bowling Green. Swankler and Schneider, it's tripping me up tonight. And they got two Schneiders,
all these centers
too.
With the S names.
Jeez. Lean went for Bowling Green in the near half wall of the zone. Clement able to work it out. Here's Ryan Savage and the rush through center ice for Miami. Feeds Pletsky over the BG line, left wing a little in front of him. They crash forward to the far corner of the BG zone. Pletsky trying to poke check it back to the line. He does so. Daskey with a puck left point. Rips it behind the net. When they stop there, Ryan Savage win the puck here to the near corner. Although he was met with a hard hit by Shaquan. They work it back to the line and keep it in the zone. Never mind, they don't. Offside. It was a bouncing pass that went back to Daskey's center blue line. It looked like he kept it in, but the linesman right there said it was not. Akeem Bennett came out of the zone, and so an offside against Miami here. It comes with 1:37 to go in the second. Gerard coming to neutral ice. on the PG right wing closest to their blue line. Monty Graham and Scartina in this draw. Clean win Miami back to the center ice area. Capstick can't shove it forward. And here's Scardina over the Red Hawk line left wing in the circle. Got tripped up. Coming through here is Olmstead. He's going to lift this puck back deep in the BG zone as Graham is going to chase after the corner, trying to beat out Malmstra. Stolen away though by Krieger. Works it up here on the near side of the ice. Bowling Green over the Red Hawk line left wing. Scardina. A nice stick there by Sinard as Scardina tried to shoot it top of the near circle. Sinard though kind of blocked it out. Went off his stick up and out of play with 1:09 to go in the second. 2-2 tie, Miami and Bowling Green. Gerard of Pearson's right coming up.
And I think what the Redhawks should really be mainly worried about right now is keeping the puck out of their own net for the next minute and 9 seconds. Because when you come into a period with a 2-0 lead, you really do not want to leave that period losing.
The two goals in the second period by Bowling Green to tie it up at 2. And Redhawks took the 2-0 lead to start the scoring of the game. Resock for Miami in his own end, works to the center ice. Redhawks can't work it over the Bowling Green line. And back deep in their own zone, here comes Barber. Trying to chip it over the Red Hawk line left wing. Goes to the near corner, Daske on the puck. Slides it to the near side for Clement. Will spin it toward the middle of the ice in the Miami zone. There's just trouble for the Redhawks in the D zone puck handling. Barry gets tripped up, coming out of his own blue line. And now we got two penalties here, one against each team. Barry was tripped by, was that Craggs? They're taking them both here. The referee, Joe Sullivan, just blew the play dead and he wants Barry to go to the box and Craggs. I guess that was a feud that was ongoing throughout the last few seconds of that play. Craggs ended up tripping Barry. Barry was trying to skate the puck out of the Miami zone. It was at the Red Hawk line. And then that's when Joe Sullivan had had enough. He just blew the play dead saying, you're both going. And we're going to be 4-on-4 here with 41.5 seconds left in the second.
Yeah, and it's interesting. Have we seen a single penalty tonight that hasn't been either behind the play or just out of frustration?
It's chippy.
Yeah,
no,
sure, sure. Ohio hockey, man.
It's another breed.
Yeah, it sure is.
So the neutral ice draw won by Bowling Green. They're going to work it out through center ice. Swankler all by himself over the Red Hawk line left wing. Slaps a shot wide of Pearson. The puck squirts out to center, and Bowling Green will regroup here in the neutral zone. Malmstrom over the Red Hawk line left wing, rips a shot over the net, kicks back to center ice. After a hard deflection off the high glass, TJ Lloyd with it, skates it over the middle of the Miami line. Lloyd all by himself, right-handed wrist shot off the skate of Daske to the far corner of Miami zone. 10 to go in the period. As this puck here kind of on the far post the Miami net, everybody trying to whack at it. Daske takes it to the far corner, gets out the lob wedge to get it to center ice. Daske, as his time expires, coming over the BG line. He didn't have a shot to put it at the net. So there's your 40 minutes in the books in the hockey game. Miami 2, Bowling Green 2 will start the third period with 1:19 of 4-on-4 time. What are you thinking after 40?
You know, not a great period, I would say. The second, it almost is like that the team switched roles about halfway through that period. For the first 30 minutes of this game, Miami was really going hard on the forecheck, really being successful on that forecheck, flying around the ice and doing a great job playing in transition. And in the last 10 minutes, they couldn't get the puck up the ice. Bowling Green was killing them on the forecheck. So we'll see if Miami can get back to what they were doing the first 30 minutes once the third period starts.
I mean, it just seemed like there was a switch turn, and it was like they were playing in Ferris State again from my vantage point after watching those games. I mean, they came out, like you said, all that energy, the home crowd, but then I don't know what it was. The dial just kind of turned back for Miami. So the question is, when you're in the locker room after 40, how do you turn it back up? I think Bowling Green showed why they are a reputable team in the CCHA this year and maybe nationally as well. Really good period by them. And you know, you make a few mistakes if you're the Redhawks in the defensive zone. Pearson, if he doesn't come out, maybe that's a save. But if you're Bowling Green, you got to be happy with your effort here on the road in a tough place to play tonight. Hey, Goggin Ice Center, Falcons got to be confident too going in the locker room in this intermission.
Yeah, that's a really great point. This, you know, Cady Arena the last few years probably hasn't been known as one of the toughest places to play in college hockey, but tonight it's got to be tough to play here because the fans are raucous. It's really impressive, actually, what Bowling Green did there in the last 10 minutes or so of the second period, coming back in this one. And We'll see. You talked about getting them riled up in the locker room. Well, if there's somebody who can do that, it's Chris Bergeron for sure. He will be. I can imagine what he's saying right now in that locker room. I'm guessing it's not very pretty, but I'm sure that these RedHawks are going to come out ready to play in the third.
And we will see for sure. Shots on goal after 40. Miami leads that tally by just one now at 19-18, so they still lead it, but not as many shots as Bowling Green. Other numbers to look at. Power play, Bowling Green 0 for 4 in this game. Miami is 0 for 2, so that's been a weak spot for both teams. We've talked about the Miami power play coming in. That needed to be strong. Only two attempts. You're not going to score every time, but Bowling Green 2 0 for 4, so the Miami penalty kill has been good tonight.
It sure has, yeah, and we saw on that last one, Bowling Green started to get a little bit more going. So we'll see if they are able to get another power play in the third period. We'll see what they can do. Hopefully Miami will stay out of the box because it looks like Bowling Green is sort of knocking on the door to scoring in one of these attempts.
And then the other numbers to look at, faceoffs led by Miami 24-17. RedHawks have 14 blocked shots compared to Bowling Green 6. That's surprising.
Those are two big numbers.
I know. And then penalty minutes led by Miami 12-8. Let's check in your out-of-town scoreboard again in the NCHC tonight. It is still a tie game in Chestnut Hill. Colorado College 2, Boston College 2. They're after 40 minutes there at Boston College. Denver has opened up a 4-1 lead over Providence after two periods there from Providence, Rhode Island. And a look at this, Jack. 3-1 Quinnipiac over North Dakota.
Wow.
40 minutes gone by in Hamden, Connecticut.
Who would have thunk?
I don't know.
I certainly wouldn't have.
No, so North Dakota down 3-1 to Quinnipiac. We'll keep our eye on that score here tonight from Connecticut as all the NCHC teams are playing out east. Any other thoughts after 40?
Not too much. Excited to see what happens in about 12 minutes.
Me too. So join us then for more third period action here in about 11 and a half, 12 minutes or so as Miami and Bowling Green will try to fight it out in game one of this home-and-home series. 2-2 tie after 40 minutes. And we're back at the end of the third period in just a few. You're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. Patrick Getcha, Jack Schmelzinger back with you here on Red Hawk Radio. 2-2 tie, Miami and Bowling Green. Our third period about to get underway. And this one will have a minute and 19 seconds of 4-on-4 time to begin this third period. Jack, what do you want to see out of Miami to start this final 20 minutes of regulation?
I think we just need to see them start forechecking like they were back in the first and the first half of the second period. And when you do that, the chances are going to come.
RedHawks move right to left across your radio here in our third period of play. It'll be a center-ice draw between Miami's Michael Rigish, Bowling Green's Taylor Schneider. And it's one here back by the RedHawks. They'll take it into their own end as Jack Clement, with the puck behind his net for Miami, kind of hits the brakes, takes a breath, comes out the near side of the net with it. It's Grisak with a pass over the center of the BG line. Grisak dances far circle, fan on a shot attempt though. And it goes to the far corner where he's pinned up against the boards by Malmstrom of Bowling Green. Malmstrom works it free, wins the battle for a second, but Grisak, good job with the body to angle him off, steal the puck away. Got it to Clement, far half wall on the right side of the zone. Now Grisak had it turned over off his stick. And here comes Barber with it for Bowling Green. Far side of the center ice, red line to dish it back. Here for Eric Parker. Parker, the play up to Austin Swankler, stolen away by Rhett Savage. Left side of the BG line, kick back to center ice, though a bad deflection. And Dylan Moulton with it here in the Miami zone, works it up the left wing boards for Barbellini. Matt Barbellini through the center ice circle, dishes left wing over the line, Daske into the BG zone. A shot up high on the shoulder of Rose. He got the shoulder on it, and it went off his shoulder and up out of play with 18:54 to go in the third period. We have 13 seconds left and 4-on-4 time. Trotter Rose is right coming up. That was the 20th Miami shot on goal of the evening. Red Savage in this draw against Ethan Scardina. He went back to the near side of the zone for Miami, but Scardina steals it away from Dylan Moulton. That's Red Savage, got it free from him, kept it in momentarily for Miami. Locks it up in the offensive zone. Red Savage, left point, through the circle, trying to dance his way around, back for Moulton, left point now, as they switch spots. Still in Moulton, with a weak shot in from the blue line, really his only option, as Miami was kind of changing one-on-one there, and it's in the breadbasket of Rose, who stops it, 18:33 to go in the third period.
Yeah, it's funny. That was almost like a punt in football. Just saw that he had nowhere to go. Just sent it right down into the glove. Easy whistle.
It's a good analogy. Toronto Rose is right. Bonnie Graham against Scardino. Scardino wins it back to the behind the Bowling Green net. Coyle spins it around the boards to the near side, where Seth Fighton is on it. Over the Red Hawk line, right away comes Krieger. Hits the brakes, top of the near circle. Shot there, patted by Pearson to the near corner of the Miami zone. They can't clear though. Coyle, right point, sends it far circle. A shot there, or a pass across the slot by Scardina. Whistled wide of everybody. Scardina back with a puck, far corner of the Miami zone. Graham trying to poke it off his stick. Scardina emerges with a puck though. Sends it in front, big rebound as Pearson made two pat saves on shots that came in there from Scardina, and another one by Seth Fighton. Hawks with a puck here below their own goal line. Olmstead far half wall, gave it up for Monty Graham, who will lift this one back to center ice and beyond. Lloyd will pick it up for BG in his zone end as the RedHawks a full five-man change. Away the pass over the RedHawk line, right wing comes Kraz, chips it off the boards, chases down to the corner. BG works it up left point. And now to the right point, Lloyd, a high shot, and somehow that puck goes at Pearson's glove. That was through traffic, the shot by Lloyd from the right point. It went through about three bodies, and Pearson just stuck his glove out, and it went right in it.
They got to be doing some sort of like mental exercises, something crazy back home in Sweden, because he just sees everything. It's ridiculous.
Here's Fletcher. Miami wins a draw on their own end. Takes it over the BG line right away. Far corner, Cassetti with the puck. Shelves it back behind the net. Malmstrom on it for Bowling Green. Leaves it up through neutral ice. Over the line right wing is Schneider. Chips it in the near corner back behind the Red Hawk net. Schnard, the off the boards indirect for Capstick, but he turned it over. BG keeps it in left point. Malmstrom shoots it in. A pat save by Pearson. Kick to the far corner. Schnard lays a shove on a Falcon down there. There's no call as Barber trying to play the puck too, but he just got hit over by the 6-foot plus Schnard. RedHawks with a puck in the offensive zone. Capstick behind the BG net, trying to center it in front. Nobody home though, Ray. And we have Cassetti now in the near circle with a puck. Gave it up for Daskus. Daskus here in the corner, working with Lloyd in a battle. Cassetti emerges with it, far corner. Back to the line, Clement. Works it off for a man coming off the bench. That's a shot by Barry over the net. Daskus there, couldn't control it. And here is Burke in the near corner for Bowling Green. Schneider to the far corner with it is Malmstrom. Cross ice look to the near side for Burke. He couldn't really do anything with the puck. Now Barry over the Falcon line left wing. Lands it back for Daskus. Top of the near circle shot. Wide on the ice, left of the net. Kick back to center ice. Barry with it right in the circle. Will scan it over toward the right wing, then turn back toward his own end. Gave it up for Regish, right side of the BG line, and the RedHawks trying to throw it in the zone off the linesman. That all turns into a cluster and an offside with 16:04 to go in the third period. Neutral ice track coming up, and a tie game at two.
Is it just me, or does it look like everyone's moving a little bit slower to
That's
start
what
this
I think.
Third period?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Tired.
Yeah, gotta be.
But two teams that had last weekend off, so.
That's right. That's that makes it interesting.
Neutralized draw one by Regish, closest to the BG line on their left wing, the Falcon left wing, goes back into the Miami zone. Drazzer with it here, far circle, the near side feed for Dylan Moulton. Works it up through the center ice area. Over the line on the right wing, comes Matthew Berry, rims it around the boards to the near half wall, grabbing it there, Grisak, couldn't really win the battle though with Parker. It's up high in the BG zone, Falcons work it out to center ice. Fights in the left wing feed, over the line is Jaquan. Gave it up though as he went back for a change. Drazner in his zone end. The right wing feed hits at the BG line. Grisak, but he misplayed as Jaquan came in to steal it away and fires it up through center ice. Back in the Miami zone where the RedHawks regroup with it. Here's Capstick. Skates it to the center ice red line. Right wing to dump it in around behind the net to the near half wall. Barry meets it there, but is unable to keep control. Jaquan stole it away. Sends it to the far half wall. BG end. RedHawks get it back. Right point, it is Sinard. Fired a wrister over the net that took a weird deflection. And Bowling Green here works it back to center ice. Up the right wing, Scardina dumps it in behind the red hot net. Capstick gave him a nice hit after he got rid of the puck. The arms stay down. Sinard lifts it back to center ice. Bowling Green takes control. Full five-man change for Miami. Here's Coyle. Pass up here to O'Hara. Dumps it in over the line of the right wing behind the net. Sinard. We'll pull it over to Capstick with 14:42 to go in the third period, tied at two. This one through the center ice area, pass picked off by Pitters. Red Savage though, great steal away high in the Miami zone. Able to work it back to center where Wozny, left side of the center ice red line, slaps it back in the Miami end behind the Red Hawk net. Pitters with a near circle for BG, a centering pass. Really unable to connect there with Schneider, who sent a weird shot well wide of the Miami net. And Capstick with it behind the Red Hawk net now, just trying to work it on the backhand out to center, and he does. It trickles back in the BG zone, near side of the zone with it is Coyle trying to go off the boards to center. He does that, and it's back in the Miami zone now where Daskus goes D-to-D on the right circle for Jack Clement. Gets it to the red line, a pass though at the BG line waiting for Monty Graham. It completely missed Graham. And goes for an icing call here against the RedHawks with 13:59 to go in the third period.
Yeah, that's too bad that that Graham couldn't corral that puck. He was sitting there right in the middle with pretty much nobody on him. Would have had a good chance to take a few steps into the zone and fire a shot off. All for naught, though. We're back in the Miami zone.
Yep. So up to the right of Pearson. Graham works it back to the corner on the clean win. RedHawks work it to the near side. Daskus emerges with it. Leads it up to the center ice area. Barbellini dumps it in behind the BG net. Rose stops it there to the near corner for Malmstrom, who's in the corner with it. Works it up the near wing boards. Can't get it out though. Daskus kept it in momentarily left point. And it was worked out by Schneider. They're kind of in a one-on-one battle. Monty Graham was behind the BG net. Did not hear the linesman yell it was offside. As that puck barely came out, and the RedHawks here will be called for the delayed offside with 13:36 to go in the third period. And we have a neutralized shot coming up on the other side of this timeout. 2-2 Miami and Bowling Green battling it out in the third period. And you're listening to Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. 13:36 to go in our third period. 2-2 Miami and Bowling Green. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger back with the air. And Goggin Ice Center tonight. Neutralized straw out of the break. Bowling Green right wing closest to their blue line. Swankler against Graham. Clean win Miami. They get it deep in the BGN. Go ahead.
Interesting line combination here from Miami. Sladek, Graham, and Pletsky looking for a little bit of speed there here for this Chris Bergeron.
And skill.
Absolutely.
Sladek down to the corner against Malmstrom. They won't call it. Works it up the near wing boards. A lot of shenanigans going on as Pletsky lost his stick. Arm staying down. Here comes Bowling Green on a rush. Up through center ice. Burke over the Red Hawk line right wing on the backhand. Got a backhand wrist shot off. Pearson barely got a shoulder on it to make the save. Rush the other way. Here comes Miami. Graham over the BG line on the right wing. Misplayed and went to the far half wall, but they're able to work it to the near corner for Moulton. Dylan Moulton in the circle. That went off a skate. Pass Sladek back to center. And Trazer here with it for Miami in his own end. Trazer skates it through the left side of center ice over the BG line on the right wing as he took a cut. It's dumped in behind a Falcon net. Rose out to stop it. Full five-man change for Miami. Fighton for Bowling Green, high in the zone, gave it up for Scardina, chips it over the Red Hawk line right wing. It's worked back to center ice as Shaquan, a bad pass to the center ice circle. Cassetti stole it, and over the line of the left wing is Daskus into the BGN. Daskus gave it up here for Fletcher. As he will be pinned up against the boards with a few Bowling Green Falcons down there. Fletcher, though, emerges with a puck. Left point, Capstick. Right point with it, Sinard. Fires it through a far circle. Went off a skate back to the near side. Bowling Green clears it there back to center ice as Capstick works it in his own end for Sinard. Sinard to Capstick near circle. Nearly turned it over in front of his net on a forecheck there. Hits Daskus over the BG line right away. We got a call coming up here on Miami. Too many men? Or is it on Bowling Green?
I think it might be on Bowling Green.
I saw a Bowling Green player literally dive over the boards. And I was thinking that maybe he just fell over trying to off the boards. I don't know, but I saw it out of the corner of my eye, so maybe he was literally diving into his bench to get back, and it is a too many men call on the Falcons.
Wow.
Joe Sullivan, the referee, blew that dead. So an untimely penalty. It's a Miami power play tonight that's over two as O'Hara's going to serve it for BG. And a draw coming here to the left of Rose.
That's a funny visual, him diving right back onto the bench. We've all been there, though.
Literally, yeah. Literally dope, like into a pool.
Everyone who's played hockey has been there for sure. I don't know if I ever quite dove, but.
I mean, this was a dive. Lean win Miami gets it back behind the BG net. Barber Laney in the left point for Barry. Center blue line Daschke. Right point for Grisak. Watch it down the right half wall to the circle, finds room. The center play in front off Rigish's skates. Chases it to the corners. Malmstrom locks him against the boards, but the puck squirts free. Grisak up the near half wall to the line. Spins around to the left point area. Dishes back for Daschke, who's at the left point. Slides across ice, across the blue line. Right point, Grisak gets it back. Down low, they work it. A return feed for Grisak in the circle. He winds up and scores! Never mind, it went off the post. The lights are off, there's no goal. Pandemonium at Goggin, and they'll just blow the play dead. What in the world just happened? The shot came in from the top of the far circle by Grisak. I think it went in the net, top left corner.
That went in the net.
The people operating the lights at Goggin thought so too. They shut the lights off as if Miami scored a goal. The horn never went off. You gotta look at this, come on. Yeah, they're gonna look at it. I thought they were just gonna announce no goal and then they weren't gonna look at it, but they are.
I thought the same thing.
I mean, that shot came in, I think it went in the net.
Yeah, I'm almost positive that thing went in the net.
And then the Redhawks thought it went in the net. They were celebrating. Then they found out it was no goal. That was the call on the ice immediately by Joe Sullivan. And then everybody scrambling for the rebound in front. You had the play just blown dead after the lights literally went off because the new thing, I guess, this year is they turned the lights off for a Miami goal.
Apparently.
And then, so the lights, it was just a flurry of action.
It really was. It was hard to keep up with.
I mean, it's hard to describe that on radio. What the hell is going on?
Yeah, we need some cameras here for that part.
I'm trying to get a look at the referee monitor below us in the penalty box. I can't make out the puck on it, though. It It either hit the crossbar of the post, top left corner, or it went in the net.
That cheer is for a puppy on the scoreboard, by the way. It was not about the replay.
Oh, my God, they got this going again. So they show a puppy on the scoreboard, and then they show the Bowling Green bench. The crowd boos when it shows the Bowling Green bench, and then they laugh or cheer when the puppy comes out.
At first, I thought, because you know when they show the replay, like in stadiums, and it's in favor of the good guys, everyone cheers. That's what I thought happened, but no, it's just a puppy on the screen.
For some reason, they never show the replay here. I don't get it.
Yeah, I don't get it either.
They're still looking at this.
Which is interesting. You'd think it wouldn't be that hard.
I know. Now they're out. Helmets are on. Joe Sullivan will give us our call. So no goal, you can tell by just the reaction. Wow. 1:20 to go on the Miami power play. And there is 11:07 to go in the third period. So I guess the puck at the post.
I guess so, yeah. I guess we owe Mr. Referee an apology there.
Joe Sullivan is a golf pro in St. Louis. That's his day job.
And
he refs
really?
Hockey on the weekends for the NCAC.
That's hilarious. Not a bad life.
No. Neutralized draw, won by Bowling Green, but in their own end, really to nobody. They chase after the puck, rocks with a good forecheck, keeping in the offensive zone momentarily, and then the Falcons clear, and a good job by fighting to just get it out.
Pearson, the roof is ready to explode off this place. Fans are really excited.
So Daskey with it through center ice. 1 minute to go on the Miami power play. The too many men call on BG. Over the line, left point is Barry. Back to the left point for Barbellini. Barry standing near half wall at the hash marks, right point for Grisak, winds up and rifles one that goes off of Barbellini's stick and out of play in front of the net. 10:35 to go in the third, 48 to go in the Miami power play, and the RedHawks now trail the shot count at 24-21. Draw to the left of Rose, features Rigich against Taylor Schneider. You just tie up for it here in the circle. Back to the right point. Daskey able to keep it in. Miami kind of won that, I guess you could say. Malmstrom in the far corner for BG. Get tied up there with Taylor Schneider, and Schneider able to work this one all the way back out. Two guys kind of tussling for it down there for a moment for Bowling Green. They're able to clear it with 30 to go in the Miami power play. Daskey out of his own end. This is back here for Grisak. Right side of the center ice red line. Chips it past Falcons. Over the BG line right away. Centers it in front. Barbellini the shot and Rose right there for the save with a chest. Point blank chance. Barbellini rim of the left circle. The lefty had a wide open chance. Right on net. Rose got the chest on it. Huge save. Remember that one later on. 10:02 to go in the third, 15 to go in the power play. Draw coming to Rose right.
Yeah, and what a play by Chase Grisak to get that puck out to Matthew Barbellini in the slot. Skated around the net, fought off a Bowling Green player with his shoulder and was somehow able to fling it around his left leg. Got it out there perfectly for Barbellini. Barbellini just couldn't put it home, but it was a great shot from a great spot on the ice.
Back to the left point, Moulton. Clean win Miami here with 10 to go on the power play. Moulton with it, center ice. Or center, the blue line rather. He's gonna fire a wrist shot just wide of the net. Fletcher far circle, works it back to the right point. Trasner holds on there, fires a wrister that went up high, deflected off traffic. Back to the far half wall of the BGN, the power play over. We're back to 5-on-5. Scardina over the Red Hawk line right away, through the circle, got a shot. Big rebound off Pearson, he never could hold on to it. And the Red Hawks come in and clear to the far half wall of their own zone. Now they got a rush. Over the line, left wing, Daskus. And he fired it off the right pad of Rose to the near half wall it went. Fletcher hits O'Hara off the puck and a pass. Miami trying to send it left point to right point. It was Daskus going to Moulton. It went off a Bowling Green stick up and into the seats. Everybody's all right down there, but it will stop play and everybody can take a breath for a media timeout with 9:19 to go in the third period. 2-2 your time, Miami at Bowling Green. Stay with us. It's Miami Hockey on Red Hawk Radio. 9:19 to go in our third period. 2-2 tie, Miami and Bowling Green. Patrick Hess and Jack Schmelzinger back with it here in Oxford. The first jump around they've had in Oxford in about 600 days. It's a tradition they do. They play jump around during a media timeout.
Oh, okay.
Move their arms around.
And, I mean, one of the greatest songs of all time. I can't argue with
that. I think so. We're 5-on-5. Miami 2, Bowling Green 2. Redhawks in the offensive zone. They win the draw. Buck here in the near corner. Bowling Green's going to have to work this one out the near side of their own zone. Redhawks with it back at center ice. They'll fling it right back in on net. Rose the glove save. Kick to center again by the Falcons. Daskey in his own end with a puck. Feeds it over the line on the left wing. Here's Graham for Olmstead. Miami the offensive zone. Graham near circle trying to center it back for Olmstead. Took a weird bounce over his stick. Puck here in the far corner. Parker trying to rim it back behind the net for Bowling Green. Has Shaquan there. Reverses the play to Parker. Far half wall. Bowling Green works it out. A bad pass there though. Went off the stick of Norris. Back in on Pearson. Miami here will regroup with time in their own end. With 8:30 to go in the third period. Daskey trying to skate it up the right side of center ice. Miami works in the Bowling Green off zone as Red Savage, far corner, works it up the far half wall for Capstick, far circle. The shot got blocked by a pair of Falcons. Schneider can't clear though, and Red Savage sends it right back behind a VG net. Here's Barbellini in the near circle for Capstick. Coming in from the corner, it drove the goal line to the net. A backhand shot that Rose saves, and bodies tumble over after that. Is everybody going in for the puck in the net area and kind of colliding in with each other, but everybody's all right down there, luckily. And we have the faceoff coming to Rose right with 8:08 to go in the third period.
No love lost between these teams, Patrick. It's going to be a fun game tomorrow.
Right?
It's already like this.
Jeez.
I mean, it feels like every other stoppage we're getting some pushing and shoving.
Rodriguez take this draw for Miami against Taylor Schneider of Bowling Green. Clean win Schneider, it goes over to the far half wall of the BG zone. Lloyd first to it, can't work it out though up those far wing boards. Nice job by Schneider to keep it in right point. Now a 2-against-3 battle that Bowling Green wins. But tripping on the puck in the corner as it came loose was Lloyd. He's going to regain control though in the near corner of his own end. Dish it up for O'Hara on the back of center ice, go the Falcons. Taylor Schneider chips it over the Red Hawk line left wing back behind the Miami net. Capstick to the far corner for Sinard. And scanning it up now is Regish. Right side Barry over the Falcon line right away. Trying to cut his way through the circle but couldn't get there as Coyle cut him off. Now Bowling Green works this one back to center ice where Moulton center circle goes team to D for Drazner who returns to Moulton left side. Renox chipped in over the BG line left wing to the near corner. Coyle first to it for the Falcons. Turned it over. Griesock at center. He feeds in front. Nobody home, but they keep it in. Drazner from the center. The blue line is shot. Deflects wide of the net. Bowling Green works this one to center ice with 7:09 to go in the third period. Buck trickles in behind the Miami net. Coyle near part of the half wall with it for BG in their offensive zone. It's rimmed around the board to the far corner. And sent all the way down the ice by Robbie Drazner for an icing call here against Miami. He just ripped that up the right wing with really no intention. And Miami's gonna have to keep their five guys on the ice here. Get a defensive zone draw with 6:55 to go in the third period.
Yeah, talk about a punt.
Fourth and 12 that time.
Yeah.
Draw to Pearson's right. Daskus in it for Miami against Bowling Green's Austin Swankler. Really not a clean win by anybody on this draw, but Bowling Green gets it back in the circle and a shot by Burke. It is right into the chest of Pearson. He made the stop there. The puck was kind of sitting on the far half wall. Burke picked it up, went through the circle, really unopposed, and got into Pearson's chest with 6:47 to go in the third period. Tied at 2, Miami and Bowling Green. Draw to Pearson's right coming up.
Yeah, that's a great shot for Bowling Green. Right about the low slot, a little bit off toward the opposite board, the bench side of the ice, but a really high danger shot, and pretty much nobody but Ludwig Pearson defending that one.
Red Savage won the draw for Miami in their own end. Far side of the ice, they'll work into center ice where BG takes it back. Parker, right point, the right side of center ice. Red line gets it over the right point to Schneider. They're back in the Miami zone as it's Clement with it here behind the Red Hawk net to the near side for Daskey. Asking near circle of his own end goes Dean and Eor for Jack Clement. The near side cross-ice feed of Barbellini went off his stick. Back to the Falcons. Schneider cross-ice look, and they're offside going over the Miami line. As it was Spencer Schneider going over to Taylor Schneider on the left side. But Taylor Schneider jumped ahead of the pass over the line. 6:17 to go in the third period. 2-2 Miami and Bowling Green. Neutralized shot coming up on the Miami left wing, closest to their blue line, Monty Graham against Austin Swankler. Clean win, Monty Graham back in the Miami zone. Capstick with it near circle. Goes cross ice to the far side. Olmstead at the center ice red line. Dumps it in behind the BG net. Rose with it here. Delays with the puck. Finally wraps it around the far side of the BG zone. And here come the Falcons the other way on a rush. Over the line right away is Swankler, but he dished it back. A drop pass picked up here by Norris. Down the near half wall, we'll get it back to the point. Lloyd gloves down the pass, skates it across the line. We'll dump it in behind the net where Pearson watches his capstick, grabs it here for Miami, steals it away, skates it up through the far circle, lifts it to center ice where it's back here on the near wing. Miami will get it into the BG zone momentarily, get a five-man change as Malmstrom back behind his net for the Falcons, spins this one down into the Miami end, off Swankler's stick. Redhawks grab it here, and it's Drasner who goes to the middle of the ice for Moulton. Through the center circle, Moulton can't get it over the BG line right away, went off his skate. And here come the Falcons. Over the line right side, Cardina, the Miami line. Cassetti stripped it from him. And here comes Bowling Green in their own end. Wazdy spins around and gets it off the center ice boards. Back behind the Redhawk net. Goes to the near corner, Miami zone. Moulton will spin it back behind the net to the far corner. Fletcher with it there, will get it to Drasner again behind the red hot cage. Drasner will skate it out of the zone, dish to the right side, Fletcher. Over the BG line right away, will kind of softly dump it into the far corner. Cassetti first to it, will tie up with Max Coyle. It goes back to the right point, Clement will slide it down the boards to keep it in. It goes to the left side of the Miami offensive zone in the corner. Fletcher there, copped it up. Here comes Fighton. He'll scan it across the ice in the neutral zone over the Redhawk line left wing. Fighton goes behind the net as the puck trickled off his stick, and the Redhawks playing good defense there to steal it away. But now it's back to the right point on a field clearing attempt, and Parker could not get a shot in. He kind of fanned on it. Fletcher right there to send it back in the BG zone. 4:20 to go in the third period. Miami on a change. Buck here at center ice in the circle. Redhawks able to steal it away momentarily as Regas goes back to Clement in his own end. Regas will lose it, trying to go up through the benches on the right side of center ice. Now a chance for Crags of Bowling Green, who came over the Redhawk line left wing. Top of the far circle shot that went off his stick, up and out of play. A timeout with 4:02 to go, and a very quick moving third period here from Oxford. 2-2 tie, Miami and Bowling Green. Don't go anywhere as this game down to the wire. You're listening to Miami Hockey on Redhawk Radio. Two to go in our third period. Drop coming up to the right of Ludwig Pearson in the Miami zone. Patrick Geshan, Jack Schmelzinger with you on Redhawk Radio. In this tie game, it's going down to the wire between Miami and Bowling Green. Sinard with it behind the Miami net. Flips it out to center ice. Parker there will dump it in right on Pearson, who makes the stick play there behind the net for Capstick. Spins it around the far boards. Miami there will grab it, take this one through center ice. Over the Bowling Green line right away was Regas. He got stripped of the puck by the defenseman back on the rush. And that was Taylor Schneider. It's sent back to the Miami zone. Redhawks with it though over the Falcon line left wing as Regas skated it from his own end. Regas will give it up though for Crags near corner of the Miami offensive end. It spins around the half wall. Clement came in to play it from the right point. a bad angle shot off a stick and out of play with 3:26 to go in the third period. And you will have an offensive zone drop for Miami coming up to the left of Rose.
How do you think this crowd would enjoy overtime, Patrick?
I think they love it, especially 3-on-3.
Is that what we're in for?
In regulation, yes.
Oh, that's really exciting, actually.
Yes.
I didn't even know that.
Draw the left of Rose is one back by Miami. Red Savage pins it up against the boards. Far half wall on his offensive end. But gave it up the whop. His stick took a weird deflection, lifted back to center ice. Here's a little breakaway. Swankler on goal. The backhand shot. Bad save by Pearson, who came up big again. Swankler to the right point for Lloyd. Top of the near circle. Fake the slap shot. Takes it down to the corner. Pass to the Miami left post of their net to Norris. He kind of lost control of it. Shot came in for the far circle. Pearson the save. He'll cover it up as it squirted off his chest and came in front of him. Ludvig covers with a glove. As that final shot, I believe, came in from Swankler again from the far side. Clock stop with 2:52 to go in the third period. 2-2 Miami and Bowling Green.
You know what's funny? It almost seems like Ludvig Pearson is fighting the puck tonight. He's having a little trouble corralling it. We saw him come out and try to play that puck last period that ended up going in for a goal. It's almost like he's having a little trouble seeing the puck, but he's still playing so well.
Yeah.
I think that just shows how good the guy is at hockey.
Rocks win this defensive zone draw. They cleared all the way down for an icing. Linos Moulton from the near corner of his own end trying to hit a pass up on the Red Hawk line and never connected with anyone. Went all the way down the ice. So the draw to the left of Pearson in the Miami zone. Rocks had to keep the five guys out there. Scardina into the draw for Bowling Green against Joey Cassetti. 2:46 to go again in this third period. Cassetti wins it back to the near corner. Drazen rips it up to the far half wall Miami zone. Fletcher out to center from there. Daskus ties up in a battle in front of the Miami bench and neutralized. Drazen comes away over the BG line right wing. Dances down to the far corner, now behind the net, and up to the near circle with a puck. And a pass there deflected on its way to Fletcher, left point. They'll have to go back in their own end to grab it. Red Hawks will. Drazner feeds Cassetti, chips it over the BG line right wing with 2:18 to go in the third period. Parker, the backhand lift to center ice. Capstick will grab it there for Moulton in his own end for Miami. Chases it back in the near circle. Dylan Moulton will hit the brakes behind his own net and work it to the slot where it's off Daskus skate. This is just lazy. Defensive zone puck handling by Miami. Finally out to center ice is Fletcher. Over the BG line, left wing, Cassetti near circle. Here in the corner, hits the brakes, spins it back to the top of the near circle. Capstick sent it through the slot, but nobody home for Miami to get that centering pass, and it's back to center ice. Here's O'Hara over the Red Hawk line, left wing, feeds Craggs, open look near circle, a wrist shot there, shouldered away by Pearson. Monty Graham with the BG line right wing, hits the brakes, up for Olmstead, far circle, he lost control to Shaquan in the circle. It's hit back to the far half wall. Olmstead for Daskey, a weak wrister from the line, that was fought off by Rose. Sinard left point, that shot immediately blocked. They try to pass it to O'Hara over the Miami line left wing, but Sinard comes in with a long stick reach and pokes into the far corner. 1:10 to go in the third period. We're tied at 2. Daskey off the high glass, back to center ice. They crash in for it in front of the penalty box. Pletsky walks in over the line before the puck as it went to him, and an offside whistle here against Miami with 1:01 to go in the third period.
It's interesting. Miami just looks so different breaking out than they did at the beginning of the game as the lights shut off for some reason. But they, like you said, it's just a little bit lazy. Instead of finding open guys up the ice, they're just sort of flipping the puck up the boards, letting the next guy do the work, and it's not working. So they should work on trying to go tape to tape a little bit more breaking out of their own zone.
The lights shutting off was an effect they tried to do a minute to go now in regulation. Puck goes into the BG zone. Shaquan sends it to the far half wall, met there by Norris of Bowling Green, but he was tied up with Regish. Finally, it squirts off the boards, but not out. Komet had it gloved down at the line, but Bowling Green will get it out from there. Here is Burke, near corner of the Miami zone as he skated it over the Red Hawk line right wing. Burke works it up the near half wall, back to the left point. Malmstrom coughed it up there, and it's sent back to center by Regish off the boards. Burke back in his own end for Bowling Green. Works this one up the right wing through center ice, goes off the stick of Grisak, out of play. He was trying to clear it down the left wing side of the neutral zone, but that puck over the glass, the wrong side of the glass for Miami. I think he got a drive coming up in neutral ice here with 25 seconds left in the third period. It'll be Red Savage in it for Miami against Ethan Scardina. Scardina, the clean win back to the circle. Boyd with it on his own blue line for Bowling Green up the right wing side, back to the near corner of the Miami end as Drazer with it behind the net, spins it around the boards to the far half wall. Ryan Savage pins it up with his skate against the boards with 10 to go in the third period. Skates the puck back to center ice. Lloyd, he will rip this one back to the Miami end with 3 seconds to go. Drazner gloves it down, takes it behind the Red Hawk net. Will kill the timeout. Regulation is over. Miami 2, Bowling Green 2. And we go to overtime in Oxford in game one of this series. A game that was led by Miami 2-0. In the second period, and Bowling Green came back to tie it at 2. There was no goal scored in that third period on either side. And we got a big OT here coming up, Jack.
Yeah, and with how sluggish, honestly, Miami looked in that third period, I think that they're lucky to be going to overtime with a chance to pull out a win. And I think that the reason is because Bowling Green didn't look that great either.
Both sides were kind of sloppy on either side of the puck in that OT period. It'll be the second time Miami has seen overtime this year. The only other time was the Saturday game against Ferris State. That was back 3 weekends ago for the RedHawks. They lost that game on the finale, the series finale, against the Bulldogs in Big Rapids by a score of 4-3. That was back on October 3rd, so about 20 days ago. So if you're Miami, you're looking at what was overall, and not to, you know, summarize this game before it's over, but you started it off really well, I thought. A lot of energy. We talked about that. They had the grit out. They had the passion out. They were playing well in front of their home fans. And then all of a sudden, it's kind of like the dial just turned down very gradually. Second and third period, BG turned it up. And if you're Miami, you've got to finish strong here, because otherwise you're just going to look at this game like, my gosh, we just can't dig out of this hole right now.
Yeah, right. And that's something that Miami struggled with a little bit last year. When you get a lead, you have to protect it. And they had a lot of trouble doing that here tonight. It'll be interesting to see where they go on this 3-3 overtime period. Speed is what's really important here. So much more ice with the fewer guys out there. And it will be interesting to see who has the advantage here. I would venture to say Miami. I don't think that Bowling Green, they're physical, they're big. They're not necessarily the fastest. I think advantage Miami here in this overtime period.
I agree. RedHawks send out Regish, Resock, and Daske. You have two forwards and one defenseman for Miami. Bowling Green has TJ Lloyd, a defenseman. They have Sam Craggs, a forward. And Taylor Schneider, a forward.
Man, I would love to see the time on ice numbers tonight for Derek Daske. Seriously,
Every time
you look down there, he's on the ice. And for good reason. But he's really steady back there. But
when you have four defensemen out of your lineup out of the 12 you have, you got to rely on those four out there. They dress seven defensemen tonight. So the center ice drop. RedHawks move left to right in the overtime. Schneider wins it for Bowling Green. He'll take it into the Falcons zone. Falcons offensive zone. Dish left point here for Lloyd. And we'll take it back out to center ice. Puck possession is everything at 3-on-3 overtime. Craggs over the Red Hawk line left wing through the circle. He was angled out by Daske behind the net. Craggs with it here up the far half wall. We'll leave it for Lloyd, right point. Lloyd with it, far half wall. Down to the corner, back up to the near circle. Took a tour behind the net. Dishes over a pass to the right circle for Taylor Schneider, who will skate it out to center. And back at his own end. It's been all Bowling Green in the possession, 40 seconds here into the overtime. They're going to turn it over here as Regis will get it back in the Miami zone. A bad pass that they could not hit to fight it. Regis will just stop here behind the Red Hawk net, try to set up a play, and Miami will change Karisak off for Matt Barbellini. You got speed out there in Barbellini. Daske, the left side feed. They come out of the Miami zone. Barbellini over the BG line, right wing, charge to the net, and he could not get a shot off on Rose. Puck squirts to the near corner. Daske picks it up. Skates it up the near half wall to the right point. Bounces it off the half wall to Barbellini. Will spin around at the right point. Hit it back down to the near circle. Barbellini just trying to keep the puck alive here with one hand, trying to go off the body of Shaquan, who was pressuring him hard. The puck squirts to center. Clement off the bench for Miami, keeps it alive, and dishes left point for Barbolini. He'll hit the brakes to the far half full against Shaquan. Barbolini, just a weak pass there to Clement. Back
yeah,
to center
gassed.
Ice, he was done. Right side feed for Rhett Savage on the BG line, right wing. He'll collide with his man. That was Fighton. They hold on to each other. The puck goes to the far corner, and Bowling Green will lose this battle here as Clement tried to kick it to Pletsky, but then it went off his stick and back to Bowling Green. They'll rush the other way. Here's Fighton over the Red Hawk line, right wing. Kind of grabbed from behind by Pletsky. Fighton was holding Pletsky's stick, and they didn't call anything. Pletsky gets the puck from Fighton. And now Clement with it near circle of Miami zone. This comes with 2:47 to go in the first overtime. Clement over the line here on the right wing. Gives it back for Barry. Near circle. A centering play in front. Could not hit Clement. Miami in a change. Here comes Swanker. Maybe on a breakaway. Over the BG Red Hawk line left wing. And a great save by Pearson. As Swanker went forehand, backhand. Really not a shot there. Pearson just made the stop. Barry hit hard in his own end. Here's Rigas over the BG line right away. He'll go through the near circle. Rigas centering play in front, and it went over the stick there of Moulton. 3-on-1 the other way for Bowling Green. Far side Swanker over the Red Hawk line right wing. To the near circle in front. Saved by Pearson on the one-timer on the post by Lloyd. And it's Barry who picks it up for Miami. The cross ice feed for Moulton, 2-on-1. Moulton near circle, his shot saved. Rebound in front. Rose made two big stops. Goes to the far corner, Moulton with a puck here in the far circle. Spins around to the slot. Dishes left point with 1:46 to go in the overtime. Barry with it through the circle, made a move to the net, and he couldn't calm down a bouncing puck. And it goes back to center ice where Moulton picks it up for Miami. Takes it back to his own end, feeds it up the right side. Barry hops over the BG line and takes it back to center. They'll regroup over the BG line, right wing Barry. Near side feed, Grisak poked away there. A great play by Schneider. He'll try to set up a rush the other way. He'll go one-on-one against Daske, who steals it from Schneider, but he'll get it back. Schneider flings it over to the right side of the ice at the center ice area. Shaquan there took it. A loose puck off the boards. Gave it to Craggs. It's over the Miami line, center of the ice. Craggs will go toward the net. Kind of a drive there. Never get a shot on Pearson. And Miami steals it away with a minute to go in a 3-on-3 overtime. P.J. Fletcher over the BG line, left wing to the far circle. Rides it here behind the net. Back to the near side is Fletcher. He'll lose control, but it goes to center, right to the stick of Daske. Luckily for the Redhawks. Daske over the BG line, middle of the ice, right to the net. He had a lane, but it was closed off by Scardina. And it goes to the far corner off Daske's stick to Shaquan with 32 to go in the overtime. Schneider back for Shaquan. The puck went loose there in the center circle as Scardina overskated it. Scardina now over the Red Hawk line right wing with a cut to the net himself and a backhand shot wide of Pearson. Parker will send it back to center ice for Bowling Green. They'll take a breath. Norris for Parker with 12 to go in the overtime. Parker with it here, sends it up the right wing boards at center ice and missed everybody. Norris picks it up in the far corner for BG in the Miami zone. 3 seconds to go. Norris is taking a tour of the zone. He has no idea how much time is left and never got a shot off after he skated it around the zone. The clock runs out here to end the 3-on-3 overtime. And are we going to have a shootout coming up? The teams are on their benches. It's always this awkward moment when you have a non-conference game, like what is going to happen next?
Right.
Because technically in the NCAA standings, this goes down as a tie. And I guess that's going to be it.
Yep, looks like it.
No shootout. Referees are talking to the coaches now, but I guess they're done too. And just a really anticlimactic ending to this one. A 2-2 tie, we saw some decent chances in that overtime period, but at the end of the day, nobody really scored. There wasn't a whole lot of shots.
No.
There was good looks, but really no shots.
And yeah, right. That's the interesting thing. That everybody was getting good looks, yeah. And people just wouldn't pull the trigger on the shot. I don't really get it. But
so we end our game in a 2-2 tie, Miami and Bowling Green. And then for Miami, it'll be the first tie of the year for them. Bowling Green tied with RPI in their first game of the year in Troy, 2-2. I'm sorry. It was just a weird way to end this game. It was such a good game played by both teams. It was evenly matched. It was good for the fans to watch, the many that came to Cady Arena tonight. And it just kind of ends with both teams sitting on the benches, and then they slowly pour out. Like, okay, we're done now.
Yeah, anticlimactic is the perfect word. Such an action-filled game ends with somebody skating the puck around the circles and not even getting a shot off.
Yeah.
Kind of weird, but how high it's hockey, I guess.
Right. So that's how game one of the series goes. Both teams tonight will get on the bus, head to Bowling Green, and play game two of the series tomorrow at 7 o'clock from BGSU Ice Arena. We will be live on the air with that one tomorrow for you from Bowling Green at 7. So if you're Miami, what are your takeaways in this game? Obviously, number one, great start. Number two, things really went downhill there about middle of the way through the game and onward. Number three, Pearson was great tonight. And I think number four, offensively, we're still seeing some issues if you're Miami.
Exactly. And I think probably the most important one of those was number one, that the start was so good. That team that we saw in the first period can hang with a lot of teams in Division I college hockey, lot of teams in the NCHC, which is the best conference in Division I college hockey. They were forechecking. They were playing great defense, moving the puck well. Passes were tape to tape. It was a really impressive first period. If the RedHawks can figure out how to get that and spread it out and make sure they play like that all the time, they're going to be dangerous this year.
I think so. And certainly for Bowling Green, I mean, really good effort by them. I think they started the game pretty sloppy, right? And eventually they kind of got their game together too and competed with Miami. We talked about on our podcast this week before these games were even going to be played about the goaltending situation, and this series was going to be really good. Mm-hmm. And in the Miami net, Pearson was excellent tonight. Zach Rose in the Bowling Green net was pretty good as well. So that's going to be a factor going into tomorrow, and I'm going to guess we're going to see the same goaltending matchup tomorrow as well.
Yeah, you would think, because both those guys were excellent. And Ludwig Pearson, 29 saves on 31 shots, but a lot of those saves were some pretty ridiculous saves. So he was even better, I would say, than the score sheet says. And Zach Rose, obviously, with a really good game too, especially in the second and third period. So a little bit of a clash of titans there. Two really good goaltenders. Excited to see what will happen tomorrow with them.
And finally, just to hit on this point, so good to have the fans back. So good for you to experience your first normal Miami hockey game as a sophomore coming in, and good to just be back in that Goggin atmosphere. And the crowd really impressed me tonight. We had a full student section, the first time I've seen that in a while, and the general admittance section was full too. So I wouldn't doubt that tonight was maybe a sellout just before the game. So really good to have the crowd back as well.
Yeah, really, really cool stuff from the Red Hawk faithful. It was super fun to watch. I had people texting me that they couldn't get into the game.
Wow.
So I think it was, in fact, a sellout. And, yeah, man, I was telling Patrick between the break, it's a lot more fun. It's fun anyway, but it's a lot more fun to call the games when the crowd is here.
Right.
So really good stuff.
I did not like the fake crowd noise last year. It drove me nuts. So it's good to have some real crowd noise here. And the fans will go home, I don't know, happy, but I mean...
probably pretty happy. They probably don't care that much.
I mean, they had a good time, I hope, and I'm sure that they enjoyed their time here, which is all that matters, and hopefully they come back next time.
Right.
Next time at home for Miami is not going to be until November 12th and 13th in a series against North Dakota. That'll be the first league series of the year at home for Miami. The Redhawks off next week. They go to Omaha on November the 5th and 6th, but before that, tomorrow's game is in Bowling Green at 7 o'clock. What are going to be some things that you will watch for tomorrow, Jack?
Definitely to see which Miami comes out and plays down in Bowling Green, whether it's the team we saw in the first period or the team we saw later in the game. It'll be interesting to see what Chris Bergeron is able to do between now and then to try to figure out how to just snatch that lightning in a bottle that we saw in the first period and make sure that everybody understands how to play that way.
Right. For those listening, we just started a weekly podcast for Miami Hockey. Tell us a little bit about that. It's through the Miami Student, which you are the assistant sports editor of.
That's right. Patrick and I co-hosting the Penalty Box Thoughts podcast. We have an interview each week.
Yep.
Week one, we had Captain Derek Dashke, a great interview with him. Gave us some really great answers. And this week, we actually had Hampus Rydqvist and Ludwig Pearson, who are best buddies from Sweden, which it was fun to talk to them, hear, you know, the stories. Not just hockey stuff, but personal stuff too, how they adjusted with coming to America, the type of stuff they do at home, you know, the type of food they like to eat. It was a really good time. So for
how they got here, that's a
exactly,
great story, too.
Crazy
to tell.
Story.
Yeah.
So for a little bit more insight on Miami hockey, check out Press Box, Penalty Box thoughts, rather, on the miamistudent.net is the website you can find that on.
Yep. So that'll be up every Friday on the Miami Student website. 2-2 your final here tonight from Goggin Ice Center. Any final thoughts?
Nope. Excited to see what they do tomorrow.
Yeah, it should be a good game between Miami and Bowling Green. We're on the air with you tomorrow around 7 o'clock from Slater Family Ice Arena. Up I-75, we'll make that trip tonight. So for Jack Schmelzinger, rest of our great crew, everybody behind the scenes at Red Hawk Radio, Patrick Geshan saying so long, good night. Thank you so much for joining us this evening here from Goggin Ice Center. Good to be back with you. It was fun.
Great to be back.
Hope
Thank
you enjoyed the normalcy.
An absolute blast.
Yeah, we didn't have it last year, so good to have that back here from Goggin tonight. So until tomorrow, everybody, thank you so much again for listening. Join us at 7 o'clock on your Saturday, and have a great rest of your Friday night as a 2-2 tie, Miami and Bowling Green this evening in this home game for the Redhawks. So see you tomorrow, everybody. Have a great rest of your Friday night.
Good stuff.